Vi snackade så mycket så man hade blivit med vår volym. När vi fick den stora så hörde inte dem. Vi skrek.
All right everyone, welcome back to another Kanal Gratis YouTube live session. Where we're gonna do fishing live and studio live.
Cool.
Och personal.
Nice hangout Sunday.
Yeah, it is. It is. Hope you guys are good. Hope you guys are good.
I'm fine, thank you.
Sorry, I'm sort of barfing over here because I'm drinking coffee and having crisps at the same time.
Yeah, we'll have some great snacks here in the studio.
Yeah. We're still hungover since Friday. That was a big final this Friday. Perch Pro is over. A little bit later in the show, we're going to meet some of the contestants. We're actually going to bring the winner here to the studio. We got a packed schedule. We're going to do open source lure building, lure design on demand.
Yeah.
We're going to paint a flat nose. Actually, this time we're going to mold it. So we're going to take it up a notch. And we got the quiz in the end.
Yeah.
What else do we have?
We have the boys out on the ice.
Yeah.
Did you say that? I didn't listen to you.
No.
Neither did I.
Tobias, Edwin and Philip, the whole Gallant team,
yeah.
I think. They were with us this Friday, but they're true anglers, of course, so they were up early, test fishing, and now they're over there fishing their spot. No, they weren't actually up early test fishing. They sort of left, I think.
Yeah.
What a release process.
It's a bit hazy. There was an after party right here in the studio. And
Fly versus Jerk.
Yeah. We had a private screening of the Fly versus Jerk that is starting next Friday. We were this close to actually doing a live drunken broadcast. No, it wasn't really that bad.
I haven't seen that.
Sarah said, it's so good you stopped it. It's so good because you're an adult, she said.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I'm officially an adult.
You have to take your responsibility.
I know. And if you're wondering what we're doing now, we're simply just buying time, making sure that Tobias and the guys in the satellite is ready to receive us. And I actually think they sort of are.
Yeah, they are.
They have a very, very... the satellite has a very... they have a clear day. Here in Stockholm, it's like super gray-ish.
Yeah, cloudy.
Yeah.
But they're not in Stockholm.
They're not in Stockholm. They're somewhere else. We can't say where, you know that, right, guys?
I think they will have a great day today.
Yeah. So, let me see if everything is good here.
Yeah.
Are we sort of on schedule?
Yeah, I think so. We're on schedule.
Mm. It's a camera.
Okay.
We are.
Yeah. All right, let's go to Tobias
Ekvall. Hi, and welcome to the ice. Right now, we are fishing. Where are the whole Team Gallant ice here? We are the whole Team Gallant team on the ice, and... Here we are, Philip. We was too many guys on the ice the last time, so he didn't have time to join us. But now he's fishing with us, so he's excited, Philip.
Yeah.
Yeah. And actually, we are fishing in a quite small lake. It's it's 7 meters of deep as the maximum depth. And actually, we have got, how many flags do we have got, Edwin?
Six.
Yeah, we have six flags and actually caught four pikes, I think. And the biggest one was the first fish, and it took 9 o'clock, and it was 100 and how long was it?
104 and around 8 kilos.
Yeah, and around 8 kilos. So it was a very, very, very fat fish.
My first pike of the day.
Yeah, it was Edwin's first pike of the day. And right now we are sitting here and we have four rods each of us, and at the same time, like during in the middle of the day, we are at the same time as we are ice fishing for pike, we are going to doing some ice fishing for perch. And I have caught some pikes here, some big perch here earlier, around like 700 grams or something, so we know they are here. So I think we could manage that to show you guys some perch also today. And yeah, what do you think, Philip, about this day?
I don't know.
The thing is that it's quite a shallow. It's some parts there are quite deep, and some parts here there are quite shallow. So we have put some roaches just underneath the ice, and some other roaches on the bottom, like 1 meter above the bottom. So. Like the half of the rods, they are just underneath the ice, and the other one, they are close to the bottom. Therefore, therefore we will see during the day which depth the pikes are, if they are closer to the surface or closer to the bottom. I want to show you Philip's ice fishing equipment here. Come here, Philip. Let's show you your ice fishing equipment. Erin?
Yes?
And here we have a glide cam. It's very, very, very extremely slippery on the ice. You know, the last time it was extremely slippery, but this time it's even more slippery. So we have to be very careful when walking. We had problem actually to reach out to go out on the lake because there were like no ice 30 centimeters out on close to the land, so we have to like jump on a rock to get out on the lake. But here we are, and this is Philip's setup. Yep. Can you explain it?
I got the ice fishing rod.
Yeah, this is his ice fishing rod. It's a kinetic, I think.
Yeah,
medium.
And a Ron Thompson reel.
Yeah, Ron Thompson reel with monofilament.
0.45.
Yeah, 0.45. And I really like his flag indicator here. As you can see, it's a snusdosa, Swedish snus. But it's not very good when it's no snow on the ice as it is today. But when there's a lot of snow, that black, it really pops. So it's very easy to see both on very close distance and on long distance. And then you have a usual, in Swedish we call it angeldom. It's a antique thing, you know, when the fish were like 10 years ago and so on, they had this thing. It works perfect when ice fishing for pike. Yeah. It's no fancy, but it does its job.
It works.
It works really good. Yes. So, but this lake, it has very clear strike periods because we was here around 7 a.m. in the morning, and then we didn't get any flag before I think 9 o'clock or something like that.
Yeah.
And then 9 o'clock, Edwin caught that 8 kilo pike. Probably we should go and take a look at it on the camera.
Yes.
Meanwhile, we are waiting for another flag here. Yeah, let's do the glide cam back. I think it's a really, Edwin, do take the sledge. It's a really nice day, as you can see. The sun is coming out, and when I'm ice fishing, I really prefer the sun because I've had my best fishing. Meanwhile, it's sunny. Yeah. Do you get any nice pictures there, Edwin?
Yes.
Yeah.
Wait.
Let's see if we can show it. Yeah. Put it down.
Fat one.
Here we have the pike we caught, the first pike.
It's a pig.
It was a really fast fish. First we thought it was like 10 kilos or something because it was so fat, but it was just 104 centimeters long. Yes. You can like switch pictures.
Yes.
Yeah, it's here. Yeah, there we have some good pictures. Perfect. We would really wanted to show that fish on the live stream, but unfortunately it took too early.
Yeah.
But yeah.
I'm glad anyway. I catch the big ones.
Yeah. Guys, Philip, Edwin, what do you think about? Oh, it's very. What do you think about the Perch Pro event?
It was very nice.
Yeah, very fun.
Very funny.
It happens a lot of fun things there, and it was really fun that
people and
it was really fun that Linus and Tom, they won the whole competition.
Yeah.
You guys in the audience that are watching this, can you please you can ask us questions and we will answer it during the time. So just ask everything you want. And of course we have ice picks on us today. Probably we can show how
to use.
No. Yeah, we put you in the hole and then you can show it how to use. But we can show how thick the ice is. Yeah. So take the drill here, the ice drill, and make a hole in the ice. Yep.
Ready.
Can you make it? Can you make it? Yeah, as you can see, it's not as thick as the last time because it's plus today. I think it's like plus 4 degrees or something. And then we have a really, really cool thing to measure the ice. Do you have the ice loop somewhere, Philip? Yeah. Here's the cam. Here we have a very good thing if you want to measure the ice, and also a very good thing if you want to take out the ice from the hole. And this, actually, I got this one from Naturkompaniet, and then you just put, yeah, you can show them how to do it. Just put this thing down there, and then you can see how thick it is. How thick it is? Is it?
9 centimeters.
9 centimeters, and...
9 to 10?
Yeah, 9 to 10, and...
It's okay,
but... It's okay, but it's very soft ice. It's not hard, so... 10 centimeters thick ice, hard ice. You can drive a vehicle on it, a car. Yeah. But I wouldn't recommend this on this ice, because it has been plus and so on. So that's about it. Yeah, that was everything from us. And ask us questions and all the time, and we will answer it. Back to the studio, to Johan and the other guys.
All right, and we're back here to Tobias. Yeah. Thank you so much for coming on board.
Looking like they have a great day out there.
They have a great day out there. They're having fun. Luke's swelling. So guys, if you have comments for Tobias and his crew out there, please drop them, and we'll try our best to deliver them to you. Mm. Now, Matilda actually had a personal comment while we were airing here about the... when you walk on the ice, and something about the cover of the...
Yeah, drill. Yeah.
About the safety?
It's easy to slip on the ice. And if you slip on the drill, you can get very damaged.
Yeah.
So I prefer to have a cover-up on the drill.
Cover-up on the drill. When you're walking around, sort of.
Yeah, if you not want to cover it up, just drill it to the ice, so the sharp part don't be up.
Okay.
So.
Yeah.
Good. And I saw a comment here. Christian, he took a new personal best on pike out on the ice. 11.09 kilos and 114 centimeters. Big congrats on that one.
That's a very big congrats. How big was it?
11 kilos.
Okay. Very nice.
Yeah.
That's
cool.
Very nice.
Out on the ice.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's great. Now, we're having some technical issues going on here in the background that you guys... Lucky for me, you can't see them, but I think we're sort of good here.
Yeah.
The guys are out there, and as soon as they get a strike, we're gonna cut back to them immediately. Okay, so this Friday, Tobias, as he said when he spoke to you from the ice, Tobias was actually with us this Friday on the Perch Pro event.
Yeah, Edwin and Philip too.
Yeah, Edwin and Philip. Everyone was there. We have roughly around 200 people at celebrating the winners and watching the final of Perch Pro.
Yeah, that was cool.
And I just want to start by saying that there might be some spoilers. Today we are going to talk about Perch Pro and who won it. So if you don't want to know...
Don't look. That's a tip.
We're going to talk about the winners.
Yeah, and they're actually coming here later in this show.
So for all you guys who just joined in, it's a good time to, because I see there's a lot of new viewers coming in.
Yeah.
This is a good place to announce that in a while we will have the Perch Pro winners with us in the studio.
Yeah.
They actually went from the party to a cruise.
Yeah, I don't understand how they
we were like,
how they did
okay.
it.
Okay.
Jesus. Yeah. But, so prepare your question for them. I'm sure they want to hear all your questions.
Please
and are happy to answer them.
I got some cool photo here from the event. It's not a good edit. But it'll give you a rough idea of what's going on. Mm-hmm. This is what it looks like when they find out that they have won, so to speak. And yeah, as you can see, it's a lot of feelings. Here we have the official Perch Pro trophy.
We couldn't find a bigger one.
No. There it is.
Yay.
So these are the official winners of Perch Pro. This is Tom.
Spoiler alert.
Yeah.
So cool.
Big spoiler alert. Oh. Girlfriend. No, it's not his girlfriend. His girlfriend's over there, I think.
Keep a track of everything, but I think you guys got the biggest Perch Pro.
I think so.
Yeah, I mean, big applause for the fly guy.
Yeah.
They caught the biggest perch.
And that was a big perch.
That was a big perch.
Yeah.
And big credits to them. Yeah. They did an amazing job. You know, we had to give them something. You
exactly.
Know? So that's very good.
I think that everyone did a great job.
Yeah.
In this.
What about?
Okay.
The live editing here. I just see that messing up.
But our background is nice, however.
Yeah.
This gray stone background.
Yeah.
Cool. Yeah. So, was that all we had, the film from Perch Pro?
Yeah.
Yeah, cool.
After that, things went, you know.
Crazy.
Yeah, we're not going to use those videos.
No, it wasn't that much.
It's what we have.
Much scandals.
Moving on here.
Can you turn down the volume on my headphones? It's screaming very
much.
Is
it screaming loud?
Yeah. But now it's good.
It's good?
Thank you.
It's because I lost my cord.
Yeah.
So I've been cranking it up.
It was so loud. I couldn't even see.
It's going to be fun when we rewind back and see how your face changes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And now it's very quiet.
Sorry, now I can hear everything. Sorry. Good. Sorry, guys.
What I got a comment here from, sorry, but I don't know how to say the name. Grace Gors, that says, Poland, love your show. You're the best fishing show ever.
Hey, thank
Poland
you.
Poland watching. That's cool.
Let's hail some nation also. Let us know where you're from.
That's always Poland. Fun. And US. I saw US.
US?
Yeah.
At the event this Friday, I took the mic and I hailed everybody, you know, like all the teams that were out there.
Yeah.
And we had fans from Canal Gratis. Fans, it sounds so ridiculous. Yeah. But followers, you guys, viewers, friends. Who came from
Holland.
Yeah, to be with us with the event.
Yeah.
They were French, Germans, and I think that's pretty amazing.
It was so cool.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's
cool
awesome.
Yeah.
And we actually got Team Flytväst Gunke with us.
Really?
Woo-hoo.
They're asking, where is the Arla guys? Arla means big pike.
Out on the ice.
The last live show. Mm. They were drinking Arla milk.
Mm.
Yeah.
They are sponsored by Arla.
Yeah. Yeah.
They wish they were.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Milk is the best drink you can drink. Love it.
Yeah.
I can hear Tobias. You can hear him, but he's screaming his top of his lungs out there. I think they're catching something. I don't know. If they do, we're going to move over to them.
Yeah.
it's actually Tobias, I'll put you on broadcast. What are you doing right now? They can hear you.
Edwin and Philip, they are like, they went 30 meters away from here and they are ice fishing perch and they caught one, really small one.
Yeah.
You're not there, you left the camera? What if someone takes it, Tobias?
I'm at the camera and they are.
Canal Gratis protocol breach. It's not
is
good.
It?
No, I'm joking. Okay. All right, bro, we cut back later. Let me know when you catch a big one, okay? There's actually rules when you work at Canal Gratis. You're not allowed to leave your bag anywhere.
Nope. Actually, I saw the camera at Hard Rock Cafe standing by the bar, and it was like a couple of minutes all by itself. And then I saw it. I just like, oh.
Yeah. She's telling on you, Tobias.
That was not Tobias' fault. I blame everyone.
Yeah. Yeah. Tobias says here in the phone, so you can't hear him, but he says that Glans was watching it.
Okay.
So we're good.
Okay, super. Yeah.
I told them also that a good thing to do when you have a camera bag sitting close to the bar and really low to the floor is to actually close it.
Yeah, the
in
camera.
In case someone spills something.
Yeah.
You know, it might help you.
Yeah, the odds is big that someone spills something in
so
it.
I'm pointing at Matilda's chest. What do you mean to? Down here, we have the Fly versus Jerk tickets link. Now, you can click it. And then you quickly realize that it's not clickable right now.
So but try it is to clickable. Lick it.
Yeah, go up in this corner here somewhere. There will be links up here. Is there a link up there?
No.
Okay, can you take care of that? Can someone from Canal Gratis who watch this event go in and...
Is it like an annotering?
Yeah,
put?
It's a card, this card.
Okay,
you can copy the cards that we have in the trailer for Fly vs. Jerk 1. Same link.
I will try to fix
and,
that.
And we will, thank you. And there will be links and the tickets are out. Because if you missed Purge Pro, you know, we got the Fly vs. Jerk that is starting next Friday.
Yeah.
And we got 6 Fridays to go. And then we're going to have the grand finale at the Sport Fishing Fair. Now, big difference here is that the Fly vs. Jerk has a much bigger stage. We're thinking maybe 800 to 2,000 people. We don't know. I think we had around 800 last year.
Yeah.
And last year we were like half the size as a channel. So we should maybe be more. And after the screening at the Sport Fishing Fair at 5 o'clock, everybody goes who has bought ticket to Enso. Enso Ballroom. That's close to the Stockholm Globe where we can cater in 500 to 800 eating people.
Yeah.
And you guys can eat. And the food is probably gonna suck, but it's gonna be the atmosphere. You come for the atmosphere. Actually, the food could be pretty good.
I think the food would be good, and it's like 3-course dinner.
Yeah, and I am gonna test eat it, you know, before. So just follow Johan Ruwe on Instagram, and you can see me test eat the food. Okay, I can't believe I just did that. That's so cheap. Yeah,
you did.
I just placed my own Instagram in there. Like,
okay,
no,
follow me too, Sarah Fishgal.
I'm just kidding. You want to drive?
Matilda Leon. Yeah.
Okay.
There you go.
Yeah.
Okay. So everyone sold everything that we can sell.
We got a question.
We got the yeah.
Can you be under 18 and be at the Fly vs. Jerk final?
You can be at the final at the Sport Fishing Fair.
No.
You don't have to buy this stupid ticket. This is for the
after
oh my god,
party.
They're drilling.
They are?
Yeah.
Okay.
The ticket that is down here is a ticket for the 3 days entrance and the dinner ticket to the after party, which is 18 plus, all right?
Yep.
There's got to be alcohol in there. But if you just, you know, if you purchase a Friday ticket, you know, you go and you watch the final of the Fly vs. Jerk. The whole package is just for the, you know.
Yeah, and
how
the
much
final...
is it? Do you remember the price?
Nope. I guess it's for
me. I don't know. Where's the link? What's the link to this card?
Tell them that story, you know.
I already forgot what I was
annotation.
About to say.
No, I'm on cards.
But we got viewers from...
Yes!
Serbia.
Cool.
We got from... They actually also like your ears today.
Yeah, I heard that. I think Albert, he wrote that it was dog ears. And
yeah.
I think this is cat ears. Or what do you think? I would say that it's
cat.
Yeah, cat.
It looks like cat
but
ears.
It could be dog ears too, so thank you. They're a little bit hard to see, but...
It's like being with a little dog.
Yeah, when I walk with the boat.
Yeah.
It's like being with a little dog. Yeah, that's cool.
Okay, I'm just curious right now. How did you felt the day after Perch Pro final?
I felt...
What did you do?
I was in the bed, but I felt pretty good. But I didn't have any Resorb, you know, it's like a little brustablett, I don't know the English word, I'm sorry. But you put it in the glass of water, it's like C-vitamin, and it's like drinking 10 glass of water. But I didn't have that at home, so
you had a hangover?
Yeah, I have a little headache, but it was okay, it was worth it.
Mm.
Did it?
I don't know how to do it right now. You should just text Pontus.
Yeah.
I'm sure it's somewhere where there is cell phone reception.
Yeah, however, the tickets, you can find them at sportfiskemessan.se.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And it's like 50 euros.
Yeah.
Yeah.
For the whole
yeah.
dinner, party, drinks, and entrance thing.
Yeah, 3 days entrance at the fair.
We'll have the link up in just a second.
And
you
I remember what
Sport
I was about to say,
yeah.
sorry. The final is the 18th of March.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
We got a question of that. So the Sports Fishing Fair is the 18th, 19th, and 20th.
Yeah.
And the final is on the Friday, the 18th.
Half past four at the big stage.
Yeah.
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 Okay. Yeah. Cool.
You can just work on those cards for a little bit more. I'm sure you can fix it.
I texted Pontus.
Yeah.
But I will. I just.
And we'll see how it goes. Okay. Let's listen in. Make sure I can hear. Tobias, are you catching anything out there? Yes, small perch.
Perch, that's cool.
Oh, yeah, perch is over. We close that Friday. Stop catching perch.
Are the perch taking the roaches or is it pimple?
Yeah, The perch are no, they're taking the small roaches.
Really?
The small dead roaches.
Oh, okay, okay, mm-hmm. okay. Mm-hmm. They're
yeah.
super dead.
They are super dead.
Yeah.
This is your segment actually, Sarah.
This?
Yeah, you should show the Niklas Broberg was top fans was on the Canal Gratis event.
Yeah.
And he actually was
no,
here.
I got a Christmas present from him.
Yeah.
And I just have to show you guys. I got this one, this nice lure with diamonds on it, and it's made by Fubik Lures, and it actually stands fish up here.
I can hold that up real close here.
And do we have split my computer to the live so I can show his Instagram just a quick?
Is it like open source time?
No, open source. No, I want to show Fubik Lures his Instagram.
All right, let's try it. I think Tom Potter's cleaned out the memory because we're looking so good on CPU right now.
Okay,
let's try it. Let's see if we can get it up.
Yeah, but however, it's Fubik Lures, and it says Sarah here too.
Yeah.
Thank you, Niklas. I love this, and I'm just like, I don't want to fish with it because
it's
so nice.
Diamonds? Did you say?
Yeah, that? It's like an accessory I want home in my room. I love it. Okay, do you guys see it? No. Yeah. Here in the background we have this awesome dude that makes these lures, and they're pretty awesome.
They are pretty awesome.
Yeah, that you can see. Fubik Lures at
they
Instagram,
look really
just
cool.
Find him. Yeah.
Fubik Lure. How do you spell that? Let Matilda do it.
Okay.
FBBYCK.
Fubik, like, yeah, like you say it. That's cool. So check it out.
We'll put a link in the description for you guys a little bit later. See how that goes.
Yeah,
so
just
drag that out there.
And please email me if you want to be highlighted as a lure builder. And we will take it up in this live show because it's so much fun with all you guys that makes your own lures. Because, yeah, it's cool.
It's a lot of fun.
Yeah. So
what about the lure building trend? Is that like going up or down, or is it like
stable? I think
stable?
It's going up.
Yeah, I see
still
it all
still
over.
Rising?
Yeah, I think.
Yeah. They're still having fun doing that? Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, well.
Yeah, but it's cool when you take your fish at your own lures. What is better than that?
No, I mean, of course. Mm. I don't have a doubt about the niche.
No.
I'm just thinking, has it reached its peak as a trend?
Okay, yeah. I think it's going up
still.
Like doing your own flies.
Also worth mentioning is that the boat fishing fair in Gothenburg is actually rolling right now. We got our friends at Alumacraft are over there going to their display. Is it actually going today on Sunday?
Yeah, it's today.
It's still today.
Also, yeah.
And I think they have this new Larsson boat at their display. I haven't seen it myself yet. This one, but this one is a pretty special one. So if you're in Gothenburg, don't forget to stop by the boat fishing fair. Oh my God. And see how the boys are doing at the Alumacraft stand. And there is actually a lot of fishing going on down there too.
Yeah.
I think they actually have a bassang.
Bassang.
Pool.
Lure pool. Oh my God.
Yeah.
Okay. Tomorrow I'll be a better person.
Get yourself together now.
Yes, I am. So guys,
I'm fixing this card thing.
Mm-hmm.
Trying to.
Did you find the link?
Yeah, I did.
Okay, good, good. Was it Pontus who assisted you?
Yeah, he didn't have a computer because I got his computer.
But he told you how to.
Yeah, he told me the link.
It's actually my mistake. I should prepare things like this before we air.
Why didn't you do that?
It's okay.
You were at the gym.
There's sort of, and there's like so many things going on, and I missed things too. It's just that I'm just better at covering it up when I do.
Mm. You do a great job, Johan.
Thank you. Now, can you see how this one is? This one is a little bit lower than this one. Hurts my eyes.
What do you want? What
see?
Do you mean?
See the graph. I'm going to take care of that. Anything else you want to add from the sport fishing fair? Like, okay, this and that. And
do you talk with us now?
Yeah, with you guys.
Sorry, I didn't listen. I was reading.
Any more information about the sport fishing fair that we can drop? Do we have tickets for the fair, for the quiz?
Yeah, we got one ticket. And I actually found out the price. In Swedish crowns, it's 550 crowns for the final and event, everything.
Yeah.
So 550 Swedish crowns, and
great.
What's that in euros?
That's like 540, 50-ish. 50 euros. Yeah.
50 euros.
I'm so bad at conversion currency like that.
Yeah.
I'm like always like, okay, it's divide. It's like, it's multiplied by 10.
Yeah,
it's
and
like
then,
10.
Yeah.
I just want to add another zero. And if it's anything more than I need to do, I don't do it. you know.
Too much work.
Yeah. It's weird. I was in Nicaragua and Costa Rica this winter, and they have Cordoba and Colones.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
I call them funny money.
Yeah.
It's little money. Actually, I think I have one here.
Yeah.
With like fishes and elephants and stuff on them. You gotta be careful when you pull up your wallet live. This can go weird. Look at
I got your
here.
Card.
Look at this.
Remember me later.
Sarah said, we're not a real family. You gotta carry a picture of me around in your wallet.
I put it in all my friends' wallets and they were just like, okay, well. It's beautiful.
Is it for your driving license?
Yeah, exactly. I got like 5 pictures. So
cute.
I spread them out to everyone that I think should watch me every day.
Yeah.
And remember me that I have your card also.
Can I please have
No, it's my wallet. Okay. And I think the link to the tickets are up now.
Good.
Try
this
it out.
Corner.
Up in this.
It's gotta be up there somewhere.
Here.
Refresh button, and then you click up there if you want to go ahead and buy the tickets for the fair.
Yeah.
Really looking forward. Like, we should do pre-screening right now, like for Fly vs. Jerky.
Do that.
Just to get everybody going. Because, you know, everybody was here. At the after party. I know a lot of people who wanted to come to my after party, but...
I wasn't invited.
No. Neither was I.
No girls. There was only boys here.
Okay.
Yeah. There were people like sleeping everywhere. It was
I saw Philip, he slept at my office.
Yeah.
In my little couch.
Yeah. And I think we should, when we have money,
one
of the things we should put on the have to buy list has to be a bar. We don't have a bar at the office.
Here.
Yeah, we should have a bar.
Here in Pontus' room, I think.
It would be perfect over there.
Yeah, but then it would be...
Why are you hesitating?
Huh?
Why do you hesitate? It'd have to be... Oh, you want to specify what's going to be in the bar?
No. I'm just thinking, if you have a bar at the office, then you would go a step further and actually do the live show when you've been to the bar.
Yeah, I think we will. We should have it over here and live from the bar.
Drinking.
There's an old show in Sweden called The Bar.
You got your mixer?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I got a mixer. Blender.
No, blender.
Yeah. All right.
Some Swinglish.
Yeah, I know. It's getting weird now. Let me see if I can bring that Fly vs. Jerk segment up. Like, I drop stuff like that and then I wait, see if I get any text messages or angry phone calls from sponsors and shit.
Yeah.
So I'll just wait for that. And no one's probably watching, so.
Everybody's sleeping. Except from Tom and Linus, because they're on the way here.
Yeah. See what happens now that we haven't officially posted our schedule? Like, we stop care about time.
Yeah. What?
No one cares.
Okay, now we should talk about the fair in like 5 minutes.
We should talk about the Fly vs. Shark, this thing. Oh. We did that for like an hour.
Yeah.
Moving on.
To...
It's actually open source
time. Yeah, it is.
Yeah.
It is.
I told you.
Yeah.
Yeah. Tobias, how are you doing down there? Sorry, can you repeat that? I pulled the wrong handle here. Go again.
Okay, we are right now ice fishing for perch, but we are just catching smaller ones, like 15 centimeters or something. And the pikes are biting at the moment, but I think we will get the strike period soon.
Okay.
And then we will get like 5 flags in 10 minutes or something.
Yes. Could you... The camera is just lying over there. Can you actually see it? Are you close?
Yeah, I'm like...
Yeah.
15 meters or something.
It's a beautiful view.
It's tilted like 3 degrees to the left.
Okay.
Hurts my eyes. Can you just level it out for me a little bit?
Of course.
Thank you. Sorry for being anal about that.
It's like
I love you to be. I see you in a while. We're going to do open source now.
Yep.
Feel free to are you watching us live from the ice?
No, I'm not. I'm ice fishing for perch.
Yeah. Okay. See you soon. Yeah. I tried to get the Stig to host the Perch Pro event.
Oh.
Yeah.
But he didn't want to come.
No.
If you haven't seen the Stig on Canal Gratis, you must go into the Stig playlist and take a look.
I wonder who the Stig is.
Yeah, me
too.
I have
no idea.
Me too. He just invoices me, so I, you know, to, so I pay him to
yeah,
do
you don't know.
To do the stuff, but so I don't know who it is. It's weird.
This is a weird number. Who could this be?
That's probably Thomas. You have to go and receive them. I will take off your. I will shut down your mic.
Hello, it's Sarah.
I think we get guests coming into the studio. We don't have studio people in the studio except the people that you see. So please get out of here. And and so we have to improvise and fix stuff for that. We have Thomas Engert arriving from Team Gunky. We're gonna have him in the studio in a little bit after the open source segment. You'll get chance to maybe talk to him a little bit. Actually,
and please comment questions.
Yeah, comment questions. Prepare questions for Thomas Engert, Team Gunky Alex. Frederick is not with us today. He had to go to France on an earlier scheduled flight. And Tom Backlund and Linus Rahners is arriving also in a little bit. We're gonna have them after Thomas Engert. Oh, finally, he's taking care of that. I don't know if you can hear me, Tobias, but it's a little bit overexposed. Oh, that's better. I like that. That's good. See how we have the V shapes? A little bit of V going on. Yeah, it's good. I like it. Hate that IKEA bag. We're going to talk about the IKEA bag and measuring and weighing fish later also. I think we're going to have to address that issue.
Yeah.
There's been a lot of comments about the points for Perch Pro.
Yeah.
And how it's people want to blame me. If they could, they would have. You know?
Yeah, I would also.
Yeah, I know. Everyone
wants to
blame me.
Yeah.
But it's interesting. I'm so glad that it didn't because I'm the ref for this.
Yeah.
So every boat has an individual ref. That's the camera guy. He's the ref. So they can rule in or rule out fish.
Mm.
They have all the sorts of power that a real ref has. Real ref. And if they can't decide on what to do, I will have the final say in everything. And even if I'm wrong, I'm right.
No.
That's what refs do.
Okay, yeah.
So I'm waiting for this show to sort of end one day by a wrongly made call by the ref, which would be right because I'm right even when I'm wrong. I'm waiting for that to happen.
You're just confusing me right now.
Hmm?
Yeah.
Yeah. What
you're
happens when an outside person or a ref have to determine the winner of Perch Pro? That's when it's going to get ugly.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. You guys know where I live, like you have my drone footage, but it's going to be bad. No, park him over there, give him some coffee, and we'll be ready for him in just a second.
I'm super excited.
Yeah. It's going to be a lot of fun. I'm bringing Sarah's computer up. Actually, this is so cool. I can master her computer with my computer.
Okay, I'm back.
Yeah, are you ready for open source? Because
I
have
I'm tired. I have the condition.
I did output your screen.
Yeah, super.
So you're good?
Yeah, we're good.
Mm-hmm. Guys, is this comfortable for you? You want the open source lure back here and this one down here? Or do you want me to cut between them? We never talked about that. Like, you never complain about how I do that stuff. You just complain when it goes wrong, and that's totally fine. But you can also, tell us how you want to do this.
Yeah.
All right. We don't have a signature song for the open source segment, but if you want to do a jingle or anything, now's the time.
I'm just good at wiggling, not singing.
Wiggle. I can sing, or what do you say?
No.
Okay.
Open source, guys. This is it. We are ready to design the Edwin Johansson flat nose lure. And you guys are going to tell us how to do it. And afterwards, when the lure is ready, we're going to publish it on canalgratis.se webpage. And you can order it today and it can ship worldwide immediately. And it should be worldwide before Friday next week. And this, I said this in the other live show, last Sunday.
Things got fucked up.
And we made them during the night, and we sent them 10:28 in the morning. They were shipped on Monday, destined for Canal Gratis warehouse, where they got lost. And we still don't know where the package is. So we had to quickly make another batch, because it's a limited batch. It's like 50 guys. And we had to make a quick adjustment, and then we shipped the other one this Friday. And some of you got the open source already, I have seen.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And already fishing with them. And you guys...
You got a video on it too.
Yeah, I do. I do. I'll show it later.
Yeah.
But I got video sent to me and everything is looking fine. Today we're doing the flat nose, which is different because this time we can also offer the possibility to add whatever ingredient you want in the rubber, because we're actually manufacturing these lures from scratch.
Yeah.
At the Canal Gratis, very super secret facility. So we can actually add flakes or whatever into these lures when we design them. So I'm gonna stop talking now and we're gonna start designing.
Yeah.
So you guys hail what you want us to do. So let's start by asking the question, what sort of base do we want for this lure? Base color, and do we want to have any glitter in it?
You go, guys. You want to know a fun thing?
Mm-hmm.
We actually got a few comments already for what color, and they actually say bananas. It's like, you know, the last live show?
Yeah.
We were talking about bananas out fishing, and now it feels like everyone wants bananas.
Really?
Yeah.
Cool.
I think it's fun.
Alright.
But let's see what they are saying.
You guys want to do a banana lure? Feel free. Actually...
Banana. No, I can draw a banana.
What?
How will I draw a banana?
Don't worry. Calm down. Calm down.
You know a banana is yellow?
Yeah.
I don't think they want like a banana.
Banana on it.
No.
Banana yellow.
She's,
okay, we'll
she's
see.
She's so smart.
Yeah.
Oh my god,
yeah.
Joanne.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yellow.
Okay, people saying yellow?
Yeah, let's see what they are saying. Just wait a second.
Panic is going on out on the ice. We're going to have to cut to the ice.
Okay.
I think there's a fish going on. No, they're investigating right now. Might be a fish going on there. Start with yellow. You guys keep commenting. We're doing a banana lure today. Is that what you want to do?
Yeah. Like,
does anyone have any objections to that? Feel free. Feel free to object.
Love the banana idea, says Rob.
Like this?
There you go. See? You know stuff.
Yeah. That exactly looks like a banana.
Yay.
Good work, Sarah.
Now.
So we go with a yellow?
Since we have the mold option, that we actually can create this lure from scratch, we're going to use that feature.
Yeah.
So we're going to put some flakes in there.
Mm-hmm. Color?
Is it okay if we put flakes in there, or do you don't want any? I'd say it'll maybe bring out the banana. I don't know. If we use some sort of yellowish thing, yeah. See.
This is glitter.
Yeah. Can we put some silver glitter in the yellow? And maybe it's a little bit of a transparent yellow.
Like this.
Yeah.
That would be cool.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like this.
Small
actually,
flake.
It can't be transparent yellow. If it is, it's not gonna be banana yellow.
No.
All right. Actually, we're going quickly over to the boys out on the ice. They are catching. Let me just quickly roll over to the satellite. The satellite is ready to receive us. There is fish going on. We'll be back soon with more open source.
I actually have a question about the ice. I wonder how thick it is.
They are already talking about it.
Not right now, but...
Yeah.
Yeah.
Fish on. Nice
hooked
one.
Up.
Is it big?
No.
It's a small one,
small
okay.
Small one.
But
ah, small pike.
It's the smallest pike for today. And like the smallest pike in a live show ever. Yeah. Okay. That's good. We caught the fish back to the studio and to the lure design of Edwin's flat nose.
Fun.
Back to the studio. Well done, boys. I'm so busy eating crisps and nuts here that I forget stuff.
It looks like they want glitter. Maybe I'm talking too fast now.
Hang on.
Yeah.
I hate my job. Go away.
But you love us.
Good point.
Yeah.
Sorry, guys. We're back. Sorry for that little interruption. Got out of my little fly versus jerk commercial down there.
Mm-hmm.
banana. So
should we have glitter?
Do they want to have flakes or glitter?
Flakes, yeah, they are committing. I can see both black and gold. It's like 50-50. And someone says other.
All over.
So I'm thinking like this. If we could add some flake shiver into the rubber to get it going banana shiny, we will do that. And we try to stay on this bright yellow as possible, close to banana. Okay, that is settled. Now, banana, if you look at the banana picture, do we have a banana here?
Yeah, outside. We have.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Because of the sugar that pushes out through the banana when it's dying, when it's decomposing, you get these brown spots or black spots on the banana. So in order, if you want to design this looking like a real banana, we're going to have to sort of, close up on there. So we're going to need a little bit of that. And we should use some black paints or some glitter to that. So we
I can do that with this one.
Yeah, and we want not the circular one. I think we want streaks.
Mm-hmm.
Sorry, there's a lot of interference. I mean, this is... this means so much to me. I'm just helping to get it to look like a banana.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. Should the glitter be there or should we take away the glitter?
I think you can just tone it down a little bit more. And guys, remember, this is a sketch. But these guys are going to be very, very well painted because they are molded right now. Means that they will be super dry when they come out of the mold. And we make them and we paint them. So the painting is going to be super good. When we did the pigs, it was a slight difference. They were molded a couple of weeks ago and sent to us from Strike Pro factory in pearl white as a base color. And when you do that, they actually, a couple of days after they molded, they release a little bit of oil and moist to them. You dry them, but since they were flown into us just a couple of days before the live show, we didn't manage to dry them super good. And that creates a little bit more transparency to the bright colors like green and stuff we had in there. So we couldn't get it to get, punch green. And normally, in a production line like this, you don't get to see the final output until we changed it 3 or 4 or 5 times. But since this is open source, learned design, live, everything is go fast. Like, of course, we do drafts, then we change a little bit before we actually go. There's people actually in the background taking care of that now. But the final output is going to vary a little bit more from the sketch than it actually do when we're doing this 6 months open source thing. Okay.
Yeah. Okay, so black stripes.
Yeah. Yeah, do some...
Where?
Randomly. Not so big.
No.
And half the brush.
Yeah. Do you know how a banana skin look like?
Does it say
banana skin or banana skin?
No. Bananas. What, are you born in the 80s? You're born in the 90s, right?
Yeah.
You eat banana skids?
No, but they're coming.
I was like,
I don't know where that comes from.
You don't know what that is.
I know that it's a candy, but I don't know how it looks.
No.
Yeah.
It's so what your mom and dad ate when they met each other at the party when they were kids, sort of. It's an old, it's old candy.
Yeah.
Okay, help me out. What do you mean? Like this or?
No, if you look at the banana here, you see those streaks? These are the sugar streaks.
Yeah.
So we need something like random. Like, yeah, that's a good one. And then you go back and do one from the other direction. Because when they burst on the banana, they don't follow a certain... There you go. I'm bringing this up at a bigger screen so you guys can follow what we're doing. You're doing great.
Looking awesome.
Looking great. Looking great. Looking great. Everyone can see the fly versus jerk. Take it down in the right corner. Okay.
Keep going.
Yeah.
I like that.
I think they should apply to the back. How are we looking on the comments? We don't want to take over too much.
No, they are starting commenting about other stuff right now. So keep to the stripes.
Now there's no fly versus jerk commercial. Keep going.
How much? I mean...
Yeah, so if you look at this banana, like this is a sort of-ish good example. I think we lose these guys. Are they still fishing? See this?
Mm-hmm.
So now this one isn't, you know how they look when they're a little bit older. Yeah. So something like that, that's good. I take that.
Maybe the opacity.
Yeah, you see that lower dot in the middle? That ruins it. So bring it up a little bit.
That one.
Yeah, take away that one and move it up a little bit more. It ruins the whole flow in the and so go up a little bit more. Sluta, sluta jaspa Tobbe, jag kör ut i sändning här. Tobbe, sluta jaspa.
Ja. Ja.
Okay, like this. What do you say? Have you, what do the audience say?
Fäll.
Okay.
Okej, Tobbe, jag kör ut det ljudmässigt här bara. Håll oss uppdaterade. Vi designar lite medans. Skrik inte för högt bara. De blir rädda. Jävlar vad upphetsad han blir. Det är en flagga. He's excited.
Okay, should we focus on what the audience think about the stripes now? Because
yeah.
They are commenting about like everything of the jig right now.
Yeah.
So,
stripes, we're still on stripes.
Yeah.
Yeah. Still
is
on
the stripes.
Stripes
good, more, less? On the back?
Yeah,
nobody.
Tell us what you
yeah.
think about
yeah.
this.
We're going to move on. But now we're on the stripe segment. And after that, we're going to move on to the nose, the fins. We have time. We're going to do this for a long time, so don't worry.
Yeah.
Okay.
Let's see.
How are you doing down there, Tobias? What, like, what is this?
Luckily, I have long arms.
Mm. Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, they let us know.
More stripes. Stripes are good. Less. They're covering
yeah.
everything. So let's see what most of the people think.
What do you think?
Everyone is commenting different things.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Is there one comment that is more than the other?
It don't look like a banana.
No, it doesn't look like a banana yet,
no.
But it will.
Yeah.
Have faith.
Edwin is setting the hooks right now.
Edwin is just going to set the hook on this fish like, oh my god.
Yeah.
Here we go.
Fun.
Good,
it's
Edwin.
It's
fight
a
it.
Good one.
No.
It's a small one.
I think a small one. 1 kilo, maybe.
Looks good.
It was taken long.
Yeah. Oh, no.
Small one.
Same size.
Okay.
Small one. Yeah.
Oh!
Yes. So, small pike. But it's gonna be a good landing here.
Nej, nej, det bit.
Va?
This is what galan sounds like.
Så.
Okay. We'll continue on the open source segment for a little bit.
Yes.
Yeah.
And while the guys are in the background playing around with that fish. Here we go. So, now we're back in the studio and can start working on that?
Yes.
Please,
yeah.
Please go, Sarah.
They're saying 50-50. 50 of the people want more, like of the black stripes, and 50% of the people want to remove them.
Okay.
So.
Remove what?
The stripes, because it don't look like a banana.
No, but they will.
Yeah.
The reason it doesn't look, we can move the stripe. Is it 50-50 on the stripes?
Yeah, I think so.
Hmm.
Yeah.
Get it. It will later on. It's because we're missing the nose in a little bit. But we can take them away a little bit later. Just keep them there for now.
Yeah.
And we will have the possibility to delete them later. Now let us know, what else do you want?
They helped me to commenting about what a banana skid, what it's like a brown belly and then it's yellow.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It is.
I've actually ate a banana skill.
Okay. Any more suggestions? Remove.
Yeah.
Yeah. We're going to have to... I see there's a big struggle here between you guys if you want to have it removed or not, but we'll get back to that issue.
Yeah.
Let's move on.
Yeah. So what should we focus on now? The tails?
Light brown upper half. I'm looking.
Yeah.
We got some fins on the flat nose.
Mm-hmm.
So there's a fin that actually applies here. There you go.
This.
Sorry for ruining it. That's the fin sort of ish.
Yeah.
And it's a little bit more distinguished on the flat ones. Do we actually have one here? Yeah.
This is what the fin look like.
Change the color.
So, we can change the color here to get it more banana-ish. See, guys, now it's more brownish, going more the banana way. Now let's start coming on the pectoral fin.
Pectoral fin.
Yeah. And
so let's see.
While you guys figure out what color you want on that fin, I will just quickly switch on the camera here and see what Tobias and the boys are doing. They claim they have a better fish. It was not. It's a small one. And
they got some action over there.
Yeah, they got some really good action.
Yeah.
Bite this on. It's a strike period.
Yep. Fun.
How do they like the brown? Yeah, a lot of brown in the comments.
Is that brown?
Yeah.
Okay.
No, we can change the brown too.
I mean, it's one sort of brown. Brown is a big word.
Yeah.
Yeah, true. Okay, yeah, so it's...
Don't change... Now it's becoming to look a little bit more like the banana skids.
Yeah. Yeah.
I think we're going to have to bring up a picture on the banana skids. I'll do it.
Yeah.
You do it?
Yeah. Or look, do you want to do it?
It doesn't matter. I have it up here so I can
do it.
Have a look.
Yeah. We got everybody going on that, so let's have a look and see.
Yeah.
Is it like this? Banana skid. This.
Oh my god.
Oof. Banana skids. Here we have it.
Mm-hmm. This is what
perfect
they look like.
Picture.
These are the So that brownish thing, you got the bright yellow in trademark, and you got the darker brown, and that's actually symbolizing the streaks a little bit. Yeah, it's the brown from the sugar, because that's what symbolizes black, brown, and yellow is banana color.
Cool.
Mm-hmm. See how I totally know stuff.
Yeah, some stuff.
Weird.
Take it away.
Take it away, please.
So let's see.
Are we okay with the fins?
The fin is perfect.
Yeah, I think so too.
I happen to change the color. Mm-hmm.
Okay, go back to the brownish. We stay with brown.
Like
okay, we're good.
Okay,
we're good. Brown petrol or pet.
Whatever.
Good.
Yep.
Now, in the beginning and in the end of the banana, there's something black here. There's something black here. Usually, at least when you show the classic picture of a banana, there are some slight green colors here and here. But we should start with just the nose. Like, what do we want to do with the nose here? Do we need something black to symbolize the... And what is the front and the rear? Do we look at it this way?
I think that's the front.
I was going to say that's the tail.
It looks... Yeah. From which way do you eat the banana?
Good one.
And you start...
From the right way.
You start.
This is where you open it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, also.
Some people open it here.
I don't like it. That part you don't eat.
No.
No.
I've never seen anybody open it here.
You haven't been to Gothenburg.
No, okay.
Then you haven't met people.
That's where all the funny people, where the funny things go.
Well, they.
Let's start with, say, what does people think?
Black. Let's see now. I'm just gonna...
Mm-hmm. Refresh?
Refresh and see what they are saying.
Can you guys hear me when I'm chewing? And is it annoying? Let me know.
Can I have
all the big
nuts?
Show have snacks.
Can I have the nuts?
Yeah.
Yeah, but in the big shows, they actually don't eat. It's just standing there to look
They have a sound guy who levels out the sound so you don't get them.
Some people say that they want... Okay, it's... I'm not going to hold it. Because I don't know which one is the front and the tail.
You don't want to insult people.
No. And there.
That's why I'm here.
Yeah, okay, hold it. So, in the front,
mm-hmm.
Which one is the front? Okay. Some people want dark brown and some want black.
Mm.
Yeah.
So we already have the eye there that is already black-ish. So let's... Give it a little black punch up there.
Black.
Let's try black, guys, and see what it looks like.
Okay.
So you can do one black. Do one streak. Yeah, like that.
Like that. And then one brown.
So banana.
Yeah, actually it is.
It actually looks like this.
Should I make it brown too? And then we can vote.
Try to... Yeah, exactly, guys. Watch. We're changing it to the brown color that of the petrol film, and we'll see. Are we getting any comments on the chewing? Is it annoying?
No, they don't comment. Actually, I can see a thing. The color that we see on our screen doesn't
so crispy.
Look. Did you listen?
No.
No. Do you want me to take it again?
Yeah, sorry.
The color that they see is not the color that we see. So they are asking if we're colorblind. Because we're seeing, you can see the fin and the yellow, it looks totally different. So they're asking if we are colorblind.
Those two brown colors look different.
If you see, if you look at the brown color there, and if you look on the brown color on our computer.
There is, yes, there is a difference.
Yeah.
Yeah, but she doesn't know how to sample that color over there, but just imagine the fire.
Yeah. It's brown.
Or can you sample that color?
Sample,
Bring out this brush, and then you sample that color.
Okay.
So you get
the same.
Yeah.
Black was better, they say.
Mm. Black was better, okay.
Yeah. But you should just show everybody that you actually know how to sample the color.
So
that everybody knows.
But they aren't the same. Should they be the same? They want it to be the same?
Yeah, exactly.
No, they want... Huh?
Hang on.
Well, what do you mean?
Too much information.
Yeah.
This one?
Yeah. Should be that one. Mm-hmm, okay. I think it was...
Hmm. So, and that's a big difference.
Yeah.
Are you happy now?
That wasn't what I meant. So,
no?
You
what
didn't
did you
understand.
Mean?
You can see the color here.
Mm-hmm.
You can see the yellow color.
Mm-hmm.
And if you look at that screen,
oh,
we see a different color than this.
We have a color-graded screen.
Yeah.
Yeah,
that's what I meant.
Our color is better.
Everybody's looking different. Hey, guys, okay, let me just explain you that to you. This screen that you're watching is graded here in the studio a little bit. So it's actually so close to the actual zero as possible of color. Now, when we shoot it to you guys, you're going to watch it on your TV, on your iPad, on your whatever. And different brand, different screens have different default color settings.
Yeah.
So you could actually, it could actually look super different.
Yeah.
And that's one of the tough things we design. When we design things in Canal Gratis, when we make our videos, we spend a lot of time, too much time, into color grading it. So we will hit the magic mark of what the average screening is. And what to do that, to go deeper into that segment, we actually go into the YouTube analytics, very, very deep, and we analyze what sort of devices you're watching on, like if you're watching on TV, iPad, or from your computer, and what the average computer is screen is in actual that country that you're viewing. This is a big area.
Yeah.
So
everyone sees different.
Yeah.
But all of the people wants black.
Black.
The nose. Yeah.
Let's hit it black. We stayed very long on that nose just to get that out of the way. But I think it's important for the open source segment to grow and get better. Everyone needs to understand why things happen. Make it a straight streak also.
Sorry.
A little bit more square.
Yeah.
No, it's good, actually. Don't mess around. Is
not,
it okay,
not
guys?
Not a little bit.
Yeah.
Is that good?
Yeah.
Okay.
Doesn't really matter because we don't know exactly the angle that is going to be painted in the...
No, exactly.
So, so far so good.
Yeah.
And we can actually use details if we move now over to the tail segment.
Mm-hmm.
We can start talking about, because we decided that this is the tail.
Yeah.
And this is the front. Bananas. How do bananas grow? They grow like this in banana plants.
Yeah.
So they start here in the beginning and they end here in the tail.
Yeah. Don't talk so much.
That one is green. What do you want to say? This one may be green.
Mm. Yeah, they're commenting that they want green. Like, Morgan, what is that?
Yeah, ripe.
Yeah, they say that the banana first in the beginning are green.
They are.
So people want some green either in the beginning or the back. I ain't gonna say which way is the beginning.
I'm thinking if we could do a whitish brownish dash to the tail. Let's stay with the tail segment here.
Yeah.
To make it go closer to this. Could you do that for me?
What color? Or, what do you mean?
Hang on. Let me ask the audience first. Do you think that's good? We're gonna recreate this end here.
So like
so the very
white
tip. We can go in and fine tune stuff later. You know, I know you guys want to put some greenish hair and stuff. Maybe for the belly, we use something green to enhance the belly. But right now, let's go straight to the tail because it's very close to banana, and let's finish it. What do you want in the tail? I mean, we could have some really cool contrast here if we go brownish blackish on the tail, like the banana. We're gonna try to replicate this. Yeah. So guys, give a suggestion. How do you, I mean, the tail is a big portion of the lure. And like Albin taught us last session, it can wiggle in front of the fish like this, fish following and seeing this. And we gotta think about it in this dimension too.
They like it.
They like the idea?
Yeah.
The black or...
Yeah. On the tail, yeah.
Yeah.
And in what, I mean...
Can you fade a color or is it just like...
We can fade.
Yeah.
We can fade.
They are coming in.
If you look at this color here on the banana, it's like brownish blackish.
Yeah. And then they are getting blacker and blacker.
Okay, so where is the black going to be?
You go like this.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, do it like that, and it's gonna be like banana style. Yeah.
Good.
It's so nice when it sort of, it just feels so good. It's so weird.
Yeah.
Like, I'm complete. So.
Yeah? Is this okay?
Yeah. Could we actually also, just a suggestion, guys. Like in this fade here, could you add a greenish color? Yellow, whitish, greenish. Bring up the color thing. And let's hear, I want to hear your comments on that, if you think that's a good idea. Can you hear us? Yeah, they can.
Yeah, we can.
I'm just checking. How are we doing on time here? How's it doing, Matilda?
Yeah, we're like, have 10 minutes left.
Yeah.
On schedule.
Mm.
Yeah. Did you put any green? Or should we put green and then ask? Or should we ask?
Yeah, put green.
What do you mean, like fade in the hair?
Just shh. Come on, be an artist. Just trust your body. There you go.
Yeah.
Mm.
Cool.
A little bit wrong green, I think.
Yeah, I think it's too slimy.
Okay, so here's what you're gonna do. Go back.
Yep.
Okay, super.
Let them in. It's the Perch Pro winners.
What's the green?
Yeah, so take the green up a little bit more so it goes towards yellow. Sorry, a little bit. Yeah, down. There you go. No, up. A little bit more. Stop over there. Perfect. And go a little bit more to left. Up. And a little bit more to left. There you go. Stay there.
Mm-hmm.
Mark that color. Save. Like, okay it. Then take the brush and make it more feathered. Softer brush. We just want to squeeze
it's,
there.
It's hard. It's
look at this banana.
You the feather is like, you can't get more feather.
Say again?
You can't get more feather. It's the most feather.
Take another brush. Take a brush that is like a spray can. There you go. And then, it's still too hard.
Yeah, but I don't know how to fix that.
Okay.
I don't.
Let me help you. Oh, sorry. I can't. I don't know Photoshop.
No, I don't think it works.
You see, the hardness is on zero.
Okay, go back. We have problems with setting the brush to softer. Do you know exactly how to do it?
We can fix the opacity,
maybe? I have no idea.
Yeah, go down on the opacity.
This was a little bit.
But what if you do the tail green first and then do the black stripe? Wouldn't that be easier
for
you?
It's not... Might be, but it's gonna be take too long time to reverse since it's just a sketch. But she needs to figure it out, like how. There you go. Stop right there.
Yeah, good.
There you go. There you go.
That looks good.
You can take it down, and you can also paint a little bit more here too, so it fades over to the rest of the body.
Maybe a little bit bigger brush.
Mm-hmm.
And more here.
Mm. What happened? It's not faded.
No, but it's the opacity. I will fix it afterwards.
No, do it now. Otherwise, it's hard to... Yeah, there you go. A little bit more here. What do you guys think? It needs to be following the line as the anal fin.
Like do you mean?
See? It's better if it stops sort of-ish that way.
Let's see. The comments
are... It's a sketch, so we don't know exactly... There you go. Oh, it's so good. Little bit more angle. Give it angle. No, just
like that.
Like that. That's better. So you see the difference?
Yeah.
It flows so much better. if it follows this angle. Actually, it should have the same angle as the anal fin. This is still a little bit more up.
Yeah. Some people like, some people don't. But you will never get everyone satisfied.
Nope. But we're going to see if there's like...
Yeah. Awesome.
Remember, this nice is going to be able to buy it in just a second. You're going to be able to click order. It's too much in the front. Pull it backwards a little bit more.
Wonder if I can use this one.
Just paint some. You see, it's too further up the body. That's why they're complaining. Because it feels so uncomfortable looking
at
it. Yeah, they're good. You're good. You're good.
Like this.
You're good. Stay right there.
They are very satisfied. Now we're talking.
Yeah, they are.
Yeah.
Ooh. See, and this is what you, this is trust. Like, you got to trust the sketch. Like, it takes time for everything to come together. But when it finally does, the output, it's amazing.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, I have a couple of questions. If we're good right here, if we're not... You know, just let us know.
Yeah.
I'm moving on to the next question here. The next question for you guys is the belly. Like, we could, there's other ways of doing it. Like, we can go one more dimension here and go white-ish, yellowish. Like, this is actually a whitish, yellowish color inside the banana. We could use that to get it sort of pearl streaky, whitish on the belly.
Yeah. Hmm? That's cool.
Yeah.
Are you hungry?
Yeah, always.
Did you eat it from the front or from the back?
I don't know.
You said you ate it from the back, but you started in the beginning.
I talked so much, I forgot.
Yeah.
Like, okay, see what they say, but I'm like...
Yeah.
I know. This is getting weirder and weirder.
Okay, I just need to be clear with one thing. They're saying that they want like a blue Chiquita sticker, but we can't use Chiquita stickers.
Hey, so smart. Like, we can't use the Chiquita sticker. But we can make a blue little print somewhere.
Yeah.
And it'll be very close to the Chiquita trademark.
Yeah. But would that be okay?
Yeah, I mean, they don't know the trademark of yellow and blue.
No, so, that's true. That's okay. Yeah, okay. Yeah.
Anyway, people see this slur, they're obviously going to buy Chiquita bananas.
Mm-hmm.
It's good.
So they should thank us.
They are actually paying me. Yeah. Sorry.
Should get that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, they're not. If I want someone to pay me, I want it to be Gainomax.
Yeah.
Which is the totally
opposite. Okay, what happened with the stomach? Should we go with or should we...
What do you say about the stomach?
We can save the little patch Chiquita thing for later.
Yeah.
That's an end thing. Like, it's so easy to
look
be.
At this.
Yeah, look at that. Oh, now you're creating. I like it when you sort of freak out on
your
own.
You're amazing, Sarah.
Yeah, it's pretty cool.
Looking good. So let's see what they are saying about the belly.
Imagine that belly with little pearl whitish inside it.
Maybe a little bit more white, lighter.
Yeah. I think yes for the sketch. Yeah. Punch it up a little bit.
Oops. No.
Don't give them that idea. Now it's Dole bananas. Use that red and you put a white line through it. It's going to be Dole. You know what Dole bananas
is? Yeah, I know, but I don't know what you're meaning right now.
She just accidentally hit red. You can see it over here in the delay.
Okay, yeah.
And I was like, if you put a white streak there too, it'll be Dole.
Oh, yeah, okay, yeah.
Do we have the possibility to do blue eyes?
No. Gold, silver, and red.
Perfect. They are satisfied.
They see the white.
Yeah.
So guys, in the tail section, it's not going to end like that. We're going to have sort of, that we wanted to sort of fade over to that green, right? Fading over to that green and then fading to the blackish thing in the back. So it's not going to be that distinguished. Looks a little bit weird. But that artistry has to happen with the final brush, so to speak. But this is getting you an idea of what is going to happen.
Mm-hmm.
So you guys want some pearl in that belly too, right?
Is this okay?
Yeah, I think so.
I'm still waiting for it here.
Right? Yeah. We'll go back.
Yes.
Yeah.
So let's see what they're saying.
There you go.
Okay, guys, I can tell you on my screen it looks more wider than it does on our screen.
Okay.
Yeah. But
doesn't matter, they get the picture.
Yeah. On our screen it's like faded white.
Yep.
Yeah. So it is they are commenting about it. That's why
they want it to be faded white.
Yeah, they want it to be faded white. So
I
just want to make sure it's faded.
Mm-hmm.
So let's see. Is the ice good? Should we change the ice? Have we decided that the ice should be silver?
No.
Or should we just focus in on...
I think we're very close to the end here.
Yeah.
What we can do is that we can we could actually put a blue striking point somewhere.
Yeah.
To sort of get it more like banana wise. And I can tell you guys that depending on where you are in the world, that blue isn't going to signal banana to you. Because in some countries, other brands of bananas are bigger. And we don't want to fiddle around too much. But we can put a blue color in there just to see what happens. If you react to that, then we're coming closer to our mark.
Okay.
Put a blue dot in there.
Where?
You want a blue striking point, guys? Let me know. Yes or no?
They've been commenting about it since we
started. They
have? Yeah.
And they want a striking point?
The blue like a striking point or
the yeah
just the blue point or what
yeah
are we...
so do let's do
yeah.
Do dot put it there
what's the
oh
blue?
Hey I know guys let's put the blue striking point in the paddle in the black paddle in the back
don't you think it would be not so good contrast between black and blue
I think it's hard
blue
to put the blue on the black Albin told us.
Okay, let's
yeah.
not do that. Okay, I got it.
To have the black, yeah.
So let's put the blue striking point over there. Poof. Just to get it out there, see what if everybody, you know, feels.
Maybe a little
that
bit bigger.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Okay, let's see. Yes.
Blue
striking point.
Yep.
It actually went.
Not okay.
It feels banana.
Yeah.
No, just one. Don't move the brush and use sharp edges.
Super sharp.
Yeah. It's a point, so you really want it to go. Poof. See what I mean? Sorry, guys.
Let's see. Yeah. Nice one.
Bigger.
So.
Take it away again.
Yeah.
Make it a little bit bigger. 30% bigger and lower it.
Like here?
Closer to the belly.
Like here?
Give me an update on the ice, Tobias. How are we doing?
Yeah, we are good. We caught one earlier and then Edwin got one right now.
Okay, good. We're with you now. Yeah. They're waiting for the big one still, they say.
They're coming that they wanted the blue on the belly. Actually, everyone is commenting about blue on the belly.
Yeah,
let's
but where,
do it.
Yeah, 100%. Okay, not the white or...
You know what? So here's what we'll do. Ask the people.
Yeah.
Do you want to remove the white or do you want the white to sort of be a part of the blue? Bluish white? Or that blue like all over the body? Like yellow blue?
I think they want this point, also, you know...
The
point.
On
yeah,
the belly.
On
the
belly.
Point. Okay,
yeah.
So go back to white and then put the dot down there.
Did I understand you right or...
Like here.
Coming.
Yeah. Actually, remove it from there and put it on the pectoral fin. We're just giving you guys different ideas.
Yeah.
Here?
This is open source, so, you know, just relax. My coffee is cold. That's going to be the next level for me in open source, when I can get hot coffee, like, constantly. I bet Malou von Sievers she's like, my coffee is cold.
Okay, but that's...
I bet she doesn't even have to ask and tell people that the coffee is cold.
Like going first class in a plane?
Yeah.
You don't have to ask people for doing things. You just see.
You don't know that you've never been first class in an airplane.
I've heard.
What are they saying?
Some people want to have like the whole belly blue, and some people want the blue spot on the belly.
Tobias? Tobias, I can hear you talking. And I'm bringing you online. Can you put Edwin on the phone? Bring him closer to the mic. This is Edwin Johansson, ladies and gentlemen. The creator of of Flatnose. I'm spitting in the studio.
So, I think he's here. Yeah.
Edwin?
Yes?
How are you doing?
Yeah, I'm over here.
Thank you. How are you doing, Edwin?
I'm doing good.
Thank you. Thank you for making this amazing lure. We're going for blue here. What do you think?
That sounds nice.
That sounds amazing. I lost him.
I'm here.
Yeah.
I think we're here. Yeah.
Yeah.
He says it's good. He likes blue.
Okay. He likes blue.
Yeah.
Yeah. He's a little bit shy than you want.
Blue belly or?
Can you try to put the dot exactly here, like we had on the green bastards? Yeah. There you go. Oh, there you go. Look at that.
That's on the gel, I think.
Look at that. What do you guys think of that? Remember the green bastard? It also has a little striking point over at the pectoral fin, like a white one.
Yeah. Actually, they want bigger dot.
Bigger dot.
Bigger dot, not that small dot.
Oops. So guys, this is the Canal Gratis .se ecom. This is where you are. We'll buy the final output in just a second. And I'm trying to find the green bastard. So.
And we need to finish the lure.
Yeah, I know. It's taking time, but it's so worth it.
Yeah.
I'm waiting for you, Matilda.
Is it going bigger?
I'm waiting for the spot. Or what do you wait for me?
The spot?
Yeah, the blue spot. They want the spot blue. So we're just waiting for it to come.
Where do they want the spot?
Exactly there.
Here.
Yeah, they're coming, but they want it bigger. So now Sarah made it bigger.
Okay, is that good? Are we good? Are we good, guys?
So let's see. It actually looks like a banana. Good work.
Yeah,
are we good? Everybody good?
We should not try out the blue. No, blue belly, that won't be a banana.
No, I think we're calling it. That's what they wanted, so.
I'm just curious about one thing. The blue dot on the fin, would it be another blue dot on the other side?
Yeah.
Cool. Yeah. Cool.
Are we happy, guys?
It looks good.
We're good?
Yay.
Yeah.
We're good? Everybody
super.
Good?
Super, super.
Good?
Okay, and the eye. Are you going to do
what eye color? Oh.
Silver. Gold.
Silver gold. Silver gold eye. You need to put all that stuff in the description when you send it, like all the details all around. And guys, the magic is over.
Are we done?
Yeah, we're done. You can now go to canalgratis.se. We look at the new project segment. Sarah is going to put it out there in just 1 second.
What
and
do you mean with...
And we need to name it.
We need to name it. So when Sarah is publishing the lure on the site, we get to name it.
So Canal Gratis do you guys want it to be named?
Ecom. Powered by. Okay, sure.
Name,
guys.
Name. And I'm going to write down the most common name.
Yep. Name this. Name it. Let me just quickly go like this.
Yeah.
And
awesome.
Don't have your mouse.
I will. I just need a screenshot because we want to be able to watch it.
Yes. Maybe we should fish with this one next time we go out.
Sorry, Sarah. That was my mistake. Now you go. Go. You go, girl. This is it. I love this. So cool. Flat no shad. Name? Question mark. Love it.
What is taking so long?
Okay, I'm getting so much funny names of...
Spit them out for us.
Actually, the very first comment that is Esok's bananas.
Esok's bananas.
You know the Latin name of
I do.
Pike is Esok's
pike.
Lucius.
Of course.
Yeah.
Of course they want Esok's bananas.
Yeah.
Yeah. Sorry guys. Yeah, I know it's unprofessional. Yeah, we know.
Okay, let's start
over. They don't hear us.
Now they do.
So they hear us now.
They do.
Yeah.
We're doing straw poll. Get ready for straw poll.
We are double. Look at the screen. Lol.
Amateur. I don't know what's going on. So many things going on. I'm scared right now.
Just okay. Breathe.
See if they can. Happens still. Actually, some of the difficulties, the technical difficulties that we had, is that the software that we're using for this is Wirecast, and it's sucks so bad.
No,
it's a shitty software.
Now you're going to have an angry email.
The new update is better, and I even bought the pro version, I think, and it's weird, like it's full of bugs. I did Livestream, which is another software. That's the one that we have for the boys out on the ice. Very stable software, like so professional.
Yeah.
But like twice the price. What can you do?
I'm working on this. The internet is not so fast, but it will come up.
So.
Yes.
And
you
I
can
just
go to my
to
office
say,
if you want to use the hardwire. If it doesn't work.
It's okay. I think it's.
You're gonna get it.
I just have to say that it's extra price today too on this one.
Extra price?
Yeah, it is.
Oh.
What is the name of it then? It's a good price, and usually I think the flat nose is 139 crowns, and now it's 99 crowns.
99 crowns, guys.
Mm-hmm.
Ship worldwide. Order today.
Yeah.
Making it today. Okay, Matilda, drop the names for us. What do we have? Top ones.
Top ones is Brutal Banana. I'm not sure if it's the same person, but I've seen Brutal Banana.
Brutal Banana, yeah.
Ghost Banana.
Banana Ghost, it has to be. Sorry.
Not Ghost. Ghost. Like Going Banana.
Oh.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And they're actually funny things. If you're from Sweden and making funny of Norwegian people, you say like banana is named Gulebøy. Yeah, they are commenting that. But I don't think so many would know what that is. But it's fun. If you're Swedish and you would think it's fun.
Gulebøy, okay.
Yeah.
I'm putting it in.
Okay, yeah.
Mm. No, that's an ö letter. I hate that.
Yeah, let's skip it. Let's see. And I got the Esok's bananas.
Banana, singulars.
Yep. Banana shad.
Banana shad. That's a better name for the lure itself.
Flat banana nose. Flat, you know, it's flat nose, flat
yeah.
Banana nose.
The flat
so
banana
cool.
Nose color. That's pretty cool.
Yeah.
Actually.
That's
the
very
banana
fun.
Banana nose color.
Yeah.
Very creative.
They are so creative with the names.
Mm-hmm.
I'm so impressed.
Yeah. You guys are the best at doing this. This is why, like, we're going to take, I told you before, this is a 3-stage rocket. We're on the second stage. A year ago, we started this. We did the first stage. Third step is going to be something else. And it's also, I think, will contain other products. Like, I want to do rods, reels.
Yeah.
I want to use, I want to have an engineer here with a 3D scan. So we can actually alter and change, and then just
that's
call
cool.
Someone or our friends like StrikePro or Vision and like manufacture this, put it in production, and we'll have it in a year, open source design.
Amazing.
Yeah. I think it's gonna happen. It is gonna happen. Just a question of when. Who's gonna stop us?
No one. Crazy banana. We got a lot of people commenting.
Mm-hmm.
I'm trying to read everyone. Everyone's commenting. So.
There's also banana. It's a slight chance that some of these already
I think it's up now. Just let me check.
How many more do you want? I got so many funny names. I can African Pike, Wicked Banana, Bad Banana,
African
good
Pike.
Luck. Good luck. We got Shitty Banana. I think I like everyone, so I won't be able to commenting about this.
Did we lose sound again? No, we didn't. Yeah, yeah. Yellow Dawn Banana. Own Bomber BS-16. That's fun.
Yeah.
African Pike. I thought African Pike was
pretty fun. I
like
that one.
That was really cool.
Should we end the one with African Pike and then pull out the straw poll?
Yeah. It's time, guys. Is it okay? Final call.
And Crazy Banana, you wrote wrong. Or with big N.
I did it intentionally.
We still got Team Fleetfest Ganku with us.
See that?
Monkey Biz. They said.
The banana.
Monkey Biz.
Oh, they're so stupid.
Okay.
Is it online, Sarah?
Yeah, but I'm working on it.
Sarah the Banana.
Ooh.
Okay, just tell me when the straw poll is up.
Yeah, we're gonna do this. We're gonna, yeah, exactly. We are.
And you can order this bait at canalgratis.se.
Yeah.
And it's up now?
Yeah.
She's working on it.
Yeah?
Yeah, there is.
Yeah,
just give her some more time.
Yeah.
Last time we got it wrong, so actually, yeah, it was crazy.
Yeah.
We took a little while before we could figure out how many that actually went.
Yeah. And I'm gonna put the straw poll on Facebook, and there you can find the...
Yeah, now, you can buy it now.
Yeah,
hang
and
on,
I
wait,
will...
Wait,
yeah.
One thing at a time.
Yeah.
Stay with the straw poll thing.
Okay.
Yeah.
Sorry. Sarah, just signal to me that you're ready.
I'm ready.
Okay, thank you. Straw poll is out. Go to strawpoll.me/675078/R.
Okay.
No, not the R. The R is for the result. strawpoll.me/675078/71.
Yes. Let's see here.
Dun, 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 dun.
Are you sure? My computer can't find it.
Strawpoll.
Yeah.
.me/675078/71.
Okay.
We good?
Yeah, we're good.
We're good.
Do you write a comment? No, on Facebook, okay.
Yeah, it's on Facebook right now.
All right. So go in there and vote. And while we do that, we can take a quick look at this beautiful web shop
mm-hmm.
that we have. You can support our work, make sure that we get good fishing films going. Oh my God. What happened?
What are you doing?
I don't know what happened.
It disappeared.
Look, the window disappeared in cyberspace.
Yeah,
oh, here it is. So cool. And yeah, you can go in there and there it is. See it? It's in new product section. If you're watching from abroad, you can go over here and you can change to whatever currency you want to shop in. You can set the site to English and you can do a lot of cool stuff here. Here it is. The Flatnose Shad Open Source 1 is live. Wow, the internet is really killing us today. There it is. Ready to buy. Bleep, bleep,
bleep, bleep, bleep. Just click buy.
I will.
Yeah, it's working.
Yeah, it's working. Well, I might actually buy one.
Do that.
Go to the register. I'm not going to buy one. Yeah. Take all sorts of payment. All of them.
Yeah.
Okay. Now we're going to stop selling stuff. Okay.
So the straw poll is out. Are they voting? Voting.
Cool. This is so cool.
It is cool.
And they will have it by
the straw poll is out. I'm just getting the studio ready. We're remodeling the studio, getting ready to take the Perch Pro winners here.
Can I go and vote? I want to vote on the names.
Yeah,
too.
Go.
Yeah.
go.
I will.
You can. I mean, we're not going to count it, but you know, we just do it to shut you up.
It's anonymous, so. God. Yeah, this banana.
It's moving. Look at that.
Yeah.
Nice.
Tobias is swearing out there on the ice. I think they have a flag. Camera's not working. This is what it sounds like when he's annoyed.
Brutal Banana. I think that was a nice name.
Brutal Banana?
Yeah. African Pike.
African Pike is leading.
Yeah,
I could totally feel that.
African Pike, can someone explain?
Say again?
African Pike.
African Pike? why it's so fun? Because you know, when you think of bananas, you think of Africa.
Yeah.
Even though most of the bananas come from the Caribbean.
Okay.
I think. Yeah. So and so, but we still think of African and bananas, and you know, African pike is just such a big contrast.
Yeah, yeah. That's cool.
Like there are no pikes in Africa.
Yeah.
So that would marry the pike to the banana.
Yeah.
So the country that is most associated with the word banana is Africa, and that's why African pike just does it so well, because secondary it makes you think of a yellow bananish pikeish thing.
Cool.
So that is the winner.
Okay.
I knew that before we took it out there.
Fun.
Yeah. I'm a sucker for naming things. That's my job at Canal Gratis.
Naming things?
Yeah.
Black tip banana. Black tip banana.
I named Tobias' new lure color that they're doing. It's still secret, but they're coming out. Tobias,
yeah, brothers
on
yeah,
the ice,
yeah,
they're coming out with this lure color. It's ridiculously good. I'm gonna show it to you later.
Oh, nice.
It's the best painted. Yeah, you can.
Oh, thank
it's the
you.
Best one I actually ever
the
seen.
The name or the.
But no, the problem is now that the lure looks so awesome, and normally they just call me in here and I look at it and I drop three names and we have one, but I cannot name it.
Okay.
Because
okay,
Tobias
I'm just gonna. Interrupt you. Sarah, can you please help me to put the straw poll in the commenting field? I don't
someone,
get it.
Someone did it here.
Okay.
Yeah, but do it again.
Team
yeah.
Pike Face, I'll just copy your
yeah.
comment.
I tried, but it...
Yeah, you can post links in this comment field.
Yeah, but
you
I tried
to... space and
whatever.
Stuff.
Thank you for the help.
Super.
Are you getting into a fight? Are you annoyed with
no.
her? A little bit? No?
Of course. You can't be with Sarah for a whole week. And
no. Exactly.
Not being annoyed with each other.
No.
Mm. Do you throw stuff at each other? Have you had your first fight yet?
No, I haven't.
No?
About a pike.
When?
In the boat.
I don't
when I left, when you were scared. There was a small fight, but not a fight.
Yeah.
Between us?
Yeah.
When I dropped the pike?
Yeah, and you get angry at me because I left.
Left. Oh, okay.
Oh my god, just drop the camera and help me!
I get panicked.
Yep.
Yeah.
It's not fun.
Yeah. But
I always drop the fish in the boat.
Yeah, but you're fun to fish with.
Thank you. You are too.
Thank you.
Okay. I think we have a winner.
Yeah.
We're at 38% on the African pike. That post is going to stay up there, but the lure is moving. Sarah is upgrading the Canal Gratis status of the pike. Please share this on your social media. Help us grow. Is it going to be like a special on the price? It's going to be like that for like 24 hours. Or
yeah,
something.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, so...
It's 50 of them, so the 50...
It's only
50,
yeah, and they're
going to...
Yeah, okay, that takes care of that. Okay.
Okay,
have fun.
Good
and
luck.
Yeah, so I'm guessing you're going to go buy one and then you're going to share it on Facebook.
Yeah, I think so.
I
yeah.
think that this is so cool. This I haven't seen a lure like this in the tackle box. It's going to be so great to have
yeah.
it there.
Can
very
you have
different.
It next weekend?
I hope so.
You're going to have to go and buy one like really fast
oh.
if you want one.
Oh, fuck.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
You just said fuck. You just, YouTube is going to pick up on that. And then the algorithm is going to rank us lower because
yeah.
you used the word fuck. You did
so
it first.
So ridiculous.
It's already in the system.
Yeah.
But it's so much fun.
Yeah.
Like, I don't care. Okay.
Okay.
Will you bring in the and switch on the mic for the Thomas Engel from Gunki Ilex? Actually, you can keep the mic on you.
Okay.
We can put him here. Bring
okay.
in an extra chair or two. Oh, we have them over there.
Do you
okay.
fix it, Matilda?
Yeah.
Yeah, super.
And we're ready.
Welcome him in.
Thank you guys for joining the
this
segment. Now we are getting the studio ready to
yeah.
receive... the Perch Pro winner, but we're gonna start with Team Gunki Ilex, Thomas Engel, who was unfortunately not the winner this year, unfortunately, but they fought really well. Thomas is a professional angler and shop owner, I think, from Germany.
Mm-hmm.
He's won the cup, the tour, and really skilled angler, captain of the Black Bass team. So much experience, fished together with Fredrik Julian, fished in front of our feet in Stockholm, and they were so close.
Yeah.
They came so close. So I can hear they're getting ready over there.
Now.
The reason I'm...
I will have these ears.
Yeah,
hello!
Hey.
Welcome!
Welcome to the show studio.
Yeah.
So can you just go
Yeah, I know, it's like a sheep studio. We're working on it.
It looks like at home with all my bases.
Yeah.
Yeah.
My wife is crazy about that.
Yeah.
Where should I...
Please.
Just, we have a seat for you here. Welcome.
Welcome.
Applause. I
Big applause,
think.
Yes, for Thomas. Ooh. How do you feel?
Good.
First of all, thank you for joining the Perch Pro
yeah.
segment. We had so much fun following you. I mean, it's you brought a lot of new ideas to sport
yeah.
fishing in Sweden.
Hope so.
And you brought the attention to us that you actually in Germany are, since it's a bigger country, your competition fishing is further developed than it is here, I think, since you have the black bass team that you have that you move with.
Yeah.
And that you actually would consider going to another country and take place in the tournament. That's a big distinguish. Like, Swedish people don't leave Sweden to go in a tournament. Sometimes, but not the way you guys do.
Yeah, we have an association in Germany, you know, who's taking care about international fishing, and I'm responsible for a predator boat.
Yes.
So I send a team to black bass, for example, and as well a team for normal predator fishing like pike, perch, and then sunder.
Yeah.
Mm.
This is the official association, the FIPS. You know the FIPS? The Fédération Internationale Pêche Sportive en Eau Douce. This is the word to say it in French.
Yes.
International Federation for Sweet Freshwater Fishing.
All right.
Okay.
And during these 3 days when you fished with Fredrik, what was hardest? Like, did you have one thing that you always had problems with? Like locating fish or?
No, not at all. We just had the problem with the weather, that the waves were so high that we could not go outside downtown city, you know.
Yep.
So we took the chance to fish more for the big fish.
Yes.
And we know the big fish are always looking for concrete, for a
structure,
tree down
yeah.
in the water with a good structure and so on. And we took the chance to fish more for the big fish, and we wait for... Hopefully the last day the weather is fine that we can go out and fish more for numbers.
Okay.
We both decide to do like this and take the risk on the last day, not fish for the big fish, fish for the numbers.
Mm.
And I think it was a good decision.
I mean, that was, you did so well. Was it like 150 fish on the final day?
151. But it was a very slow start in the morning.
Yeah.
We catch some pike, they cut off the line and so on. And honestly, in my head, after so many pike, I thought we are in the wrong place.
Yeah.
But Frederik say, I believe in this place. We should stay. And not long ago, it's like turning a key, you know, turning a switch.
Yes. It goes on.
The perch start to bite.
Yeah.
I believe they are already there. They are hiding in the small grass on the bottom with no movement. They don't waste any energy.
No.
And then the boss of the perch, now it's dinner time.
Now it's time. yeah, exactly. Did you get into discussions with Frederik, like, oh, I want to go here, and you who actually has the final call in the boat when you need to make a captain decision, sort of, like,
how
do you do that?
You know, in every boat, you can only have one captain.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And Frederik is Frederik's boat.
Yeah.
First. Second, he knows much more better Sweden
yes.
than me. I was fishing Sweden one time, 10 years ago. A friend of mine has a house.
Yes.
Here in Sweden, and I fully accept that he say what we do or where we go.
Yeah, so he has.
We are fishing as a team, you know.
Very interesting, and that's something that doesn't always come on camera. But you guys can see some of the struggles that the teams have when they debate and discuss things. And some of the team have a very thought out plan when it comes to that, and some of they don't. I'm not going to drop any names here, Stefan Trumstedt and Albin Schargi, but sometimes they get into interesting argument, and it's going to be down to sort of coincidence in the end that decides what to happen. And I think we're going to see a lot of change in that in the future for Perch Pro. Like, we can already see on the fly versus jerk that is upcoming now, there is more robust fishing, more robust plans. And more leadership coming into the characters that are into this.
All the teams will learn about this event.
Yeah.
And will try to do next year better, have a better plan.
Yes.
You need a plan B, a plan C, and even maybe a plan D.
Yeah.
Mm.
If something don't work, you should have something else in your pocket.
Yes.
To put out.
Give me 1 second here, Thomas, and let's see if we have any comments from
we
you guys.
Actually
if you
have many comments
questions.
From Germany.
Sorry, let me just quickly ask. Do you have a phone on?
Bzz, yeah.
Bzz, bzz? You need to kill that. That's also killing. Yes, let's roll some questions around Matilda.
Can you read the questions, Matilda?
It's in German.
Yeah.
I actually been reading Germany for German. You say Germans.
German.
German. Yeah, German. For 4 years.
Yep.
Yeah. Yeah.
Show off.
Yeah.
I'll just back up a little bit so you guys can see each other also.
I'm not a pro, but okay, I can't read them.
Okay.
It's too hard.
It's too hard.
We have from Felix Müller. Hello, Thomas. Wie geht denn so?
Oh, it's just he asked how I'm feeling.
Yeah.
Is everything okay?
Yeah.
I can say yes. It's okay.
Okay,
I'm feeling fine.
Super.
Yeah.
Cool.
Funny.
Yeah, we have so many comments here. You can read it.
Is there a question going more deeper inside of fishing or?
This is a German comment.
You can translate for us.
That one. Masseleis der Hechte nicht mit Wobbler.
Isn't Hecht pike?
Is it just Swedish people trying to make fun?
No, they are complaining about that you are losing a bait inside the mouth of the fish. Of course, the cut off the line.
Okay. Yeah.
And they asked me to fish with a wire leader, and I have to say, after this experience, we changed to a wire leader. Of course, we don't want to damage the fish, and we don't want to lose our baits.
But
we are fishing for perch, you know, and this was a real perch area. And we were a little bit surprised that. Okay, the first pike could be an accident, then the second one, and then we changed to wire leader.
Yes.
You couldn't have done that better, I think.
No,
because you want to start with a softer leader because of the presentation, I guess.
Because of the better presentation, but then when we see that there are a lot of pike, both of us change.
Yeah. You adapt to
That's
the situation
good.
And
yeah,
you go
course.
For wire.
We don't want to damage the fish, of course.
No.
I'm going to agree with that. I heard that's how it went down, and we also have seen it a little bit in the show, and you compensated for that situation very good by doing so, for sure.
You know, especially for the surface baits, you normally not start with a wire leader.
No.
Of course, you are a little bit damaging the action of the bait. But if we do fishing for perch with small lures, where I'm coming from in my lake in Germany or in River Rhine, we are using a very fine wire leader.
Yeah.
Something like titanium or so.
Yeah.
And we don't feel that the catching rate is slowing down.
No.
So,
why
for
not
security
stay with
it, and for to help the fish, I think it's okay.
Yes. What about the Coke thing?
You know, I first saw that and learned to save the fish.
Yeah.
It was in a world championship in Mexico on black bass. I could get the first real big one, and the bait was very deep in the mouth, and the fish started to bleed. And the driver of the boat tried to help the fish survive. It's on the one hand, the fish only count when it's in good condition. On the second hand, we don't want the fish to be dead.
Yeah.
So he opened the mouth, opened a can of, you can also use for all the people who look now, Sprite is also very useful.
Okay.
Yeah, it must be some sugar, some acid inside, and then it stops immediately
the
bleeding.
Yeah.
Then you can put out the hook in a good way, or you manage to not damage the fish. And we put this fish in the life well, and 3 hours later, still in real good condition.
Okay, great.
You have to take care that they don't lose blood.
Yeah.
If they lose blood, you know, in such a fish, maybe there is such a small glass
full
of blood, and
not
if they are losing half of that, they don't gain enough oxygen.
Okay, that's very thoughtful of you, and being such a big representative in the sport fishing industry, taking your time to do that on camera, like when we saw you guys did that, we were like, okay, it's weird that they give them Coke, but they probably know what they're doing.
Yeah.
We're gonna air it because
I have done it for a reason.
Yeah,
yeah,
for sure. We did a lot of Googling afterwards, but it seems like you're doing the right thing here. So well done.
We got a comment here from Klaus that he says that there are studies that pike lose their baits after a few hours, even they were hooked with triple hooks.
Yeah, they do. I mean, the hooks actually rust off and they will lose the barb and the lure will eventually fall out. There are studies.
Yeah.
But
so that's good.
But if they're bleeding, it doesn't matter if the hook loses or not. It's still going to be there and the fish is going to bleed out because it can't stop its own bleeding so easy. So therefore it helps. Okay, moving on.
Okay, I got a question from... No, it's not an appointment from Team Flytväst Gunki. And they said that they tried to put coke on a roach, but it died instead. So can you only use it for
I have
You used too much coke.
Yeah.
Okay.
Or maybe there was something in the coke.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay.
Yeah.
Coke
yeah.
Zero.
Yeah.
Honestly, I have not experience with roach using that. Of course, I'm coming from the coarse fishing. Yeah? This is my first profession.
Yeah.
Honestly, normally you use a small instrument to just put it out without any damage.
Mm.
So very, very few you have this problem.
Yes. Yeah.
So we never use it to.
Do we actually have any real questions?
I actually saved a question from the morning. And it says like this.
Who asked it?
Vanligt jävla fiske.
There you go.
Vanligt.
Scheisse fiske.
It says, ask Thomas what fluorocarbon he's used for mainline, since most people don't use it, and what's the upsides if you compare it to braid?
I am using actually...
First of all, before you answer that, let me just quickly explain to everybody.
Yeah.
What he's want to know is, why is using the benefits of using a fluorocarbon line instead of braided, and braided flätlina, ni vet, istället för fluorkarbon, alltså plastlina kan man säga, istället för tyglina eller fiberlina. And it's important to know the distinguish because it's quite kind of new to everybody.
Yeah.
So I'm sorry, I just want to point out, that's the question. Please, Thomas.
It's quite simple. The fluorocarbon line is not so noisy as a braided line. That's the first point.
Because when it goes through the loops and the... Oh, sorry, the...
Yeah,
the
no, rope. No, just if you make some action underwater, you know, the line is singing.
Oh, yeah.
And possibly the fish hear more your line than your lure.
Yeah.
Especially when you're fishing soft plastics, you have good vibrations underwater, but you have not many noise. So the line is more noisy than your bait. And could be that this is... for the fish, something they fear.
Mm.
So I use mainly no braided line. I use a fluorocarbon on my bait casting reel for bait casting reels. The stiffness of this special monofilament line is not a problem.
Okay.
It's just spooling it, you know.
Okay. Yeah.
But with a spinning reel, it's different. We have this spiraling.
Yeah. On the bait caster, it shoots off.
So
like this.
Some companies now try to make this line a little bit more softer. But what is the advantage? If it's only the noise, you can also use a normal a nylon mono, for example. The thing is that fluorocarbon have, with a small weight on, a very, very, very low stretch. So... it's not the same as with braid, but it's not far away from braid, from this point of view.
Yeah.
So if you fish for the perch, and I don't look for my line, I mainly concentrate on my hands, you know, I feel the tick-tick, and then tick-tick, boom, fish on.
Mm.
This is the advantage of a fluorocarbon, and the people say it's harder to see.
Harder to see.
So we often combine...
Because of the transparency.
If we have to use braided line for maybe vertical fishing in wintertime in a deeper water, we make 4 or 5 meters of fluorocarbon in front.
Okay, yeah.
This also is good for, let me say, when you fish on the bottom, dragging a little bit, and you make a stop, you get a little bit of slack line. We don't see that, but
it happens.
Of course, this line is 1.5 times more heavy than the normal line. And a PE line, a braided line, is... almost swimming, so you get this, and when the fish grab the bait, there's not many tension against.
Not a lot. Okay.
So he can put this little slack line completely to get the fish, the bait deeper and better in the mouth.
All right.
Not many fishermen think about that.
I didn't think about that. It's so I'm like, okay, tell me more. Like
later.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm gonna have to go back to this session later and check it out. Guys, time is moving fast, and do we have any more questions?
Let's see.
If there is any, feel free. Otherwise, we're about to round this up. Are you going back to Germany today?
Yes.
Yes? Back, and will you keep on fishing perch now for a while, since you've been doing this and maybe preparing for next season and
yeah. You know, I'm not just fishing for perch.
No.
I'm doing so many things.
Yeah.
I'm the national team for feeder fishing as well.
Yeah.
And fished last year the World Championships, of course.
Is this a full-time job for you?
This is a full-time job. Working for Sensors Company, Elex Gunki and Starbates.
Yeah.
And in my free time, I'm going fishing.
Yeah.
And mainly, if possible, I go for a competition, of course.
Yes.
Fish competition since I'm 12 years old, and I find it really more interesting than going pleasure fishing.
Yeah.
Yeah. There's two people on the boat. You have seen maybe the last hour where we use the small nitro shed.
Yeah.
In such a quick matter, you know, we catch one fish after another. This is typical behavior of competition fishermen. They don't lose time.
No.
And Frederick is doing this job for a long time as well.
Yeah.
So I think we are a good team.
And you are.
Definitely. When I'm coming home on my lake where I'm fishing most, there is now close season.
Okay.
Yeah. So we give the perch a rest.
Yeah, yeah. You're gonna have to give it a rest.
When we want to go fishing, we have to go elsewhere, or start fishing a little bit for coarse fish.
I have a personal question also that I've been thinking about, and I actually don't know, but if do you have a favorite fish? Like, this is your favorite one. I know it's a corny question.
It's not, of course, I'm sitting here for the perch pro.
Yeah, I know.
But the perch I like most.
Yeah, it is?
Yeah. Perch and black bass.
They
are real similar, these two fish. And
a lot of people are talking about, since the perch pro is new here in Sweden, in Europe, and we have this wonderful possibility to broadcast sport fishing for the world like this. It's a good competition between us and other sports now. And also, it's a competition within the sport fishing segment itself, between the species. Pike has always been the top fish in Sweden when it comes to, you know, the nerds or the enthusiasts of the sports.
Yeah.
But for the general people, it's been roach and perch for a long time. And of course, we spotted this, and this is also why we moved into perch pro segment from the pike era. What do you think for the future? If this goes on and we have fly versus jerk and the fishing segment is growing, do you think that actually perch will sort of outnumber the pike? Will the industry be bigger around perch in the future? Or do you think it will be the same? Or
I believe it will be bigger.
It will be bigger,
It's more fun.
Yeah.
You have much more numbers on perch than on pike.
Yeah.
That's the first point. It's, let me say, easier to get success.
Yes.
You know?
Yeah.
And
I think
perch fishing, especially with all this new finesse style with drop shot, wacky, and so on, this will be a big hype.
Yes.
I'm sure.
Yeah. Do you have any questions for yourself, for the audience? There's a lot of people watching. You can think about that for a while. If you have anything that you want to ask them, feel free.
Okay, I can say, keep your line always wet if you want to catch a fish.
Yes.
And never stop learning and never give up.
All right.
You have seen the last fish, the last cast, and the last fish.
Yeah, yeah.
If you don't make this last cast, if you give up before, you don't catch the 151.
No,
and
exactly.
You don't gain the point.
No, exactly. No, that's very, very true.
We got one question from Multiskinnet, and he wonders if we will see you next year in Perch Pro.
Maybe it's not settled yet. I know that you boys will have a team represented.
If there is a chance to come,
mm-hmm.
It's an honor for me to come.
Yeah, okay. You want to come in the competition.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
But next year we don't play so much around.
Okay.
This you can transmit to the other teams.
Yes, yes, exactly.
Next year we close the lid.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. It's good.
This was a little friendly. This.
But
we can do in a different manner.
Yeah, exactly. I got it. It's good.
No, I think congratulations also to Stockholm Fiske.
Yeah.
They were leading from the first day,
so
they really deserve.
They deserve it for sure, on
number one.
Yeah.
So
the boys are actually here. Yes, we're gonna bring them on in a little minute.
Okay. But next year maybe it's a different story. I hope so.
Yeah, I think so. Yeah, I mean the format is changing all the time. We're doing small adaptions
and of course,
we are very young, doing this.
So
it's we have a lot to learn still, and we're open to all sorts of input from you guys and of course from our competitors or very experienced in this field. Okay, okay guys, cool. Let's bring in the winners. Yeah. And Thomas, so good to have you on the studio.
Yeah.
You're going to fly back home or you're going to drive?
I'm now taking a taxi to Arlanda Airport and then fly home.
That sounds good. That sounds safe and good.
That all right. Safe. So, bye.
Thank you.
Nice to meet
thank
you.
Thank you. It was a pleasure.
Nice to
hope to see you again soon, Thomas.
Yeah.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Bye. Guys, a big applause for Thomas as he's leaving the studio. Well fought. Extremely professional. And as you heard, this is a high-level angler doing this full-time. This is Albin Sharge's dream guy.
Yeah.
Like
he knows what he's talking about,
for
sure.
Yeah. And also, these guys are giving, like in the beginning, you know, it was mostly like flams and trams in Perch Pro and Fly versus Jurgens.
Yeah.
Still is a little bit, because it is entertainment. But we are getting, as the format climbs and gets higher and more serious, we get more and more input on how to tweak the show, how to make it more competitive. And it's going to get harder as we grow.
Yeah.
You actually think it will be easier. Some things will be easier, but a lot of things will be harder. Keeping the format interesting is going to be a big challenge for Canal Gratis. We're working on that. And also make it interesting for the competitors to actually fight. Because, of course, they enjoy the good show, but really, they're not here to make a fun show. They're here to win.
Yeah.
So we got to be able to satisfy the competition heads in this format as well. So, still working on that. Guys, get ready for Stockholms Fiske. If you have questions for them, it's now time to start thinking about them. Are they ready out there?
I think so. They looked ready before when I got Thomas.
Yeah.
Matilda is going to get them.
Do you want them beside you?
You or if you scoot over a little bit more than that. And
okay, you fix that and I go get them.
We so need another studio for after the fair, after the sport fishing fair
maybe
is
they
over.
Don't have to see me in the camera. I can sit like this.
You can.
Because it's the winner's time to shine.
It is.
Yeah. Hello.
Hello.
Welcome, guys.
Can you move a little bit?
Big applause for the Perch Pro winners. Stockholms Fiske. Fiske.
Fiske. That's cool.
Tom and Linus.
Yes.
You know how to speak now?
No, not yet.
We have the video for the. I watched it this morning. It was pretty fun.
Yeah.
Yeah, you looked a little bit shocked there. So, let's talk about Friday to start with. Did you have a good night?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, you look fresh.
Yeah, today I look fresh. Yesterday was quite worse.
Yeah, yeah.
And I don't sleep so much, but I slept 8 hours now.
Yeah.
And back on track.
Yeah.
Yeah. So you were there this Friday, and we actually have some cool video. Let's look. Have you seen any video of yourself?
No.
No. Let's have a look.
On YouTube.
Yeah, it's gonna be on YouTube.
Yeah. Cool.
Also. Give me 1 second. And let's see what we got here. Perch Pro event, here it is. It's okay, it's not gonna be any crazy pictures or anything. It's just, you can be calm. I edited this the good way. There were women screaming after you and stuff. Like I put.
That's my mom.
Yeah, I know.
I met your mom.
Yeah.
She's very nice. I like her.
Yeah. So this is you guys. I'm just making sure that they can hear me. Yeah, everybody can hear us. And guys, let me know that we're a bit far away from the mic, but let me know if you can't hear the voice or anything. This is the event, and you're sitting in the middle, so everybody can see you guys.
Yeah.
And that's pretty cool with these events that you don't know the results.
No.
You find out when they find out.
Yeah.
And then an hour after, the whole world finds out when we air the show.
Yeah.
So I'm just explaining it so that you who haven't seen it knows. And let me bring in, let's do something fancy here. Let's get you guys in there.
Skunky says Linus was awake 37 hours.
Yeah.
Is that
yeah.
true?
Yeah, that's true.
Good job.
That's good. So here you are now. Sorry, guys. You're going to have to give me a minute.
Yeah, you get a congrats from Germany.
Ooh,
I have
Germany's watching.
This is the actual moment when you guys find out that you are winning.
It was a close one, though.
Yeah, it was close, close, close. What did that feel like?
So great. So so great.
Weird, yeah? You were sitting with the Gunky guys, you had that table. And on the other table, we have Vision and CVC.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Here comes the fun trophy.
Oh, that was quite heavy to carry home.
Yeah, I saw that. Did you take it on the subway or did you get a cab?
No, we had the car, but he parked.
Yeah.
Too far away from Hard Rock.
So the fly guys had they had the biggest perch of the tournament.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's a really good dog.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think that's fun. And they deserve it.
Yeah. They fought hard.
Yeah.
And their plan was actually to catch big fish. And a lot of people say that in this format. Our plan is to catch a big one, but then they don't.
Mm.
Trust me, they don't. I filmed this for quite a while now, and it's having people staying on plan is the toughest thing. That's why we have the reports.
Yeah.
It's to mess you up.
Yeah.
To
yeah,
make you lose focus,
so
change your plan, and get information that sort of changes the variables for the day. And that always works.
Oh.
It's the same for everybody. And the fly guys, they sort of stayed on plan, and they succeeded. They caught a big one. Did you ever think about changing your plan? Like, we've seen the Perch Pro, but
no,
did you have a backup? Like, let's go here, let's go there.
No, actually, we went there because of the pressure.
Air
pressure, yeah. We didn't know, like, 5 minutes before we left here, we wasn't 100% sure if we were going to hit Lake Mälaren or...
Or go somewhere
or
else.
Down somewhere else. So,
really?
Yeah,
so you decided that morning?
Yeah.
Wow. That's amazing.
So if the weather had been better, we surely would have stayed around here.
Yeah. Okay. And then what would have happened, you think? What would the strategy be if you stayed here? Linus is like, poof.
more fish.
More fish?
Yeah.
More numbers?
More numbers, but not the
you were,
one.
Yeah. You were heavily criticized in the first episode of Catching Small Fish.
Yeah.
And I think it was, you did it perfect. I mean, you're supposed to look at rules and know how to just fly like really close to what you're supposed to do and get away with it. That's how you win things.
Yeah.
And that's how you progress. You go outside your comfort zone. And you did that. You did well. You caught an amazing amount of perch. You were criticized. And we changed the rules for the sake of all the little perch. we raised the bar to 25 centimeters. And immediately when that rule applied, I thought you and I was going to get into a discussion, but you just dropped it. You were like, I don't care.
No, it's rules. I played by the rules.
I'm sorry, Tom, we're not going to count 3,000 perch this episode. We have 25 centimeters. And you were like, yeah, so you play by the rules. And I think that's the amazing thing that is a little bit forgotten in the comments right now is that you actually adapted so well to this situation. Amazing.
Yeah, but the rules are the same for everyone. So
yeah, they are.
There's no problem.
No. It was funny this Friday when we announced the winner and you guys knew. And one of the first things you said when you took the mic was like, well, I never fished that spot before. But it was fun.
Yeah.
That's amazing.
But fishing is like that. If you know how to fish and how to find them, I don't think it matter if any secret spot or
it's a little bit
like
about
that.
The knowledge on the spots too, absolutely. But it's all about the anglers.
Yeah,
yeah, you have to know how to hit them.
How to hit them, yeah. What was the let me see it quickly here. How are we doing on questions?
They're talking about some Facebook thing that you gave away some stuff to a guy.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, can you tell us a little bit about it?
Yeah, there was a handicapped guy with his, I don't know what you call it, carrier or what you say,
something like
yeah.
that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It takes care of him at daytime, and I felt so sad
yeah.
for him. It was so beautiful done. So I decided to give away some stuff.
Well, that's beautiful.
Yeah.
So I was listening in with Tobias here for a second, so I just missed how that started. What was that?
It's comment here about they did some. Wait, let me find. Big Death Stockholms Fiske gave away stuff to that boy on Facebook.
Okay, got it.
Yeah.
Got it. Okay, yeah, that was that one.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, that's very, very big.
Yeah, that's nice. And some people are commenting about the Red Ghost. How would you have done without the Red Ghost? Would you have won the competition anyway?
Oh, yeah, we would have found something
yeah.
else, but it's a great bait.
Yeah.
You can't say anything else. It's a fantastic bait, but we also had a... many fishes on the nitro shad.
Mm.
Nitro shad 90.
Yeah.
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 I think
a lot of them.
Yeah, a lot of the big ones came up on the nitro shad, and but no, I like the Red Ghost.
Red Ghost
the
again. Red Ghost again. Yeah, for sure. That's cool.
Okay, and yeah. Any
and
more
you,
questions?
You also see that we always use natural colored baits.
Yeah, for the most.
Yeah, for the most. It's not often that we go by, you know, fluo colored baits or something like that.
I'm watching the comments now. A lot of people that are congratulating you guys, of course, for this. It is amazing. And yeah, Red Ghost.
Tosta wonders about the reel. What reel would you suggest to use for perch fishing?
That depends.
Yeah.
This year I was stuck to the spinning
yeah.
reel that I was using because of the wind.
Mm-hmm.
Otherwise I would use a bait caster, and to be real honest, I only use Shimano reels.
Okay, yeah.
So you're a shop owner, how long have you had your shop?
I think it's 6 years now.
6 years?
Yeah.
Yeah. And that's the best way to meet Tom and Linus, because Linus works in Tom's shop.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's in Bro. Is it called?
Yeah, it's in Bro. Yeah.
In Bro.
Just outside Stockholm.
And you're online.
Yeah. Online.
Stockholmsfiske.se.
Yes.
Yeah.
Is that it? Yeah. Can you buy the Red Ghost?
Yeah, of course.
Yeah. It's in
yeah,
stock.
We've been shipping Red
yeah.
Ghosts like crazy.
Yeah, because I'm reading the comments. It's sold out. Obviously, you can go to Stockholmsfiske and get the Red Ghost.
Yeah.
Yeah.
How many do you want?
Yeah. We have some
yeah.
in stock.
Yeah. You're going to have to go back there now and start packing, you know that,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, I know. It's going to be shit Monday.
Yeah. So speaking of the lures and the industry and all the lures that becomes attractive after tournaments like this, is this how you want to live your life? Like fishing tournaments like this and run the shop? Is it a good lifestyle?
Yeah, it's a good life.
Yeah.
Yeah. I started the shop because I love fishing.
Yeah.
And, I wanted to get the lures that I couldn't buy at other stores. So.
Yeah. It's a passion-driven sport,
yeah,
and you're a passion-driven
passion,
businessman.
Yeah.
Yeah. Very cool, very cool.
Mm-hmm.
Linus, how old are you?
24.
You're 24?
Yeah.
So have you fished perch a long time?
For all my life, absolutely, but not serious.
No?
For serious, like 4 years or so.
4 years, okay,
yeah,
okay.
Really serious.
How long have you been working with Tom?
That's 2 years now.
2 years.
2 years.
Yeah. All right, cool. So what do you think that this will do to you and your fishing for the upcoming years?
We film a lot with the Team Fleet Vest.
Yes.
And that's where we start. See how it goes?
Yeah.
Like that?
Yeah. You don't have a super plan. It's like...
No. Just...
Take it as you go.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Living the dream.
Yeah.
Living the dream. Niklas.
It's weird. I also think I'm very honored to have you guys with us, because we're struggling with tackle shops in Sweden. It's so good that... I mean... When you look at these guys are the future of sports fishing and the future of tackle shops in Sweden and probably in the world, because this is the way the good tackle shop have lived their entire lives before, up to the digital revolution. But then it was just physical tournaments, and you had to go to so many of them to reach out to a lot of people. Today
yeah.
you can attend just a couple of them if they have cameras like the Perch Pro.
Yeah.
You can get a lot of attention on your shop. And Kanalgratis has a web shop, and you guys have a web shop, but still we're not enemies. Like, we speak every other day,
yeah.
and it's great.
And that's a little bit what the future is going to be like. And therefore, we're extra glad to have you guys on board, of course. Because it's a real...
I think it's important that everyone cooperates
in
the business.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah. You shouldn't be enemies. You should work together.
I mean,
get the sport fishing even bigger.
We couldn't have done Perch Pro if it weren't for you guys. Like, we couldn't have enough teams to do the format. So it was a big save when you came on board.
Yeah.
It was actually Niklas Bauer who introduced me and Tom for the very first time, I think.
Yeah, I think
so. And if you guys hadn't come on board for the first season, it wouldn't have happened. It might have happened, but it had happened later. And so these guys have been contributing a lot to the sport fishing industry this year. We all have a lot to thank them for, so thank you very much.
We have a comment here from Niffler. Do you just fish soft baits or hard baits too?
For the most, soft baits.
Soft baits, yeah.
Yeah, but sometimes it all depends on what you do and how depth it is and everything like that.
Yeah.
I should say like this, in the summertime I use more hard baits because it's easy to fish with vibration baits in the summertime when the fish are faster.
Yeah, and we got another question here. What lure would you take on to a lonely island? Just one lure.
Red ghost.
Yeah.
Yeah. Probably.
Red ghost. So you can yeah. Okay.
Because it's actually kind of good on even sand or pike.
Yeah.
You have the big 13 centimeters that are completely forgotten, that are crazy when you're going for big sander and pike.
Yeah, that's cool.
For sure. Trying to follow the comments here. See, this is what I wonder where Matilda went.
You want me to go and check on her?
Maybe.
So she's alive.
I'm just yeah. So maybe she locked herself out.
Oh.
Because the door, you know. Because my phone is going back and forth also all the time. So maybe, I don't know. It's weird.
There.
Very, very good. Well, Rusty Amin wants to know, what was the toughest process during the competition?
The dead periods.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The one we don't see on
camera. It looks so easy.
Yeah, it's just six shows, 30 minutes of hundreds of perch jumping in your boat, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
But it's definitely not like that.
If we want to symbolize the waiting time, when it's awkward waiting time and it gets on your nerve, we will give the viewers a blank of 5 seconds.
Yeah.
With nothing happening. Down. Yeah, exactly. If we want to create huge discomfort, you go above 10 seconds with nothing.
Yeah.
If you go past that, people aren't gonna view. I mean, you're gonna ruin it for yourself.
No.
But it gets amazingly uncomfortable after 15 silent seconds when you're watching someone. Like that. Right.
Yeah.
That's a trade secret you got there. The dead periods. That's the toughest one.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Because you're always thinking about if the other teams are fishing like crazy and. So it's tough.
It starts to building up in your head. How is the reports? Did they bother you a lot?
Yeah, of course.
Yeah.
Yeah, we thought a lot.
Yeah, you always it's a stress moment, of course. Yeah.
Did they have any influence on your fishing more than I know it put stress on you, but did it actually make you change your tactics when you get?
I'm quite stuck to the tactics.
I fish faster.
Yeah, you fish faster. Yeah, because that's
more perch.
Now you need to keep calm.
Yeah.
To catch them, you have to feel everything. If you're stressed like he was.
Yeah.
And he loses it.
Yeah.
Every little bite.
Thomas was here a little bit earlier and we spoke about who's the captain of the boat when he needs to make a decision. Do you have like a plan like that?
It depends on the spot.
It depends on the spot. Hey, now it's getting interesting. Would you care to explain a little bit more about that?
Yeah, if I know the spot, definitely I should call.
You're making the calls.
Yeah.
Yeah, trust him for a while. Till I see if he's right or not.
Yeah.
Until I'm proved.
I get it. Okay, so a little bit more listening into to who knows the information.
Yeah.
About the spot. Okay, interesting. Let's see if there's any more. Do you have any more, Sarah? Björk Lekander says we should tell you about the open source alert that we made.
Quick look on the banana.
That looks hideous, but let's put it down there for a second. This is the open source flat nose chat. Do you like it, Tom?
Yeah, it's gonna be a hit.
You think it's gonna be a hit?
Oh yeah.
Okay, it's amazing. If
I'm
you
gonna
say
buy
that,
one for Linus.
Yeah, exactly. No, it's a kick-ass lure. It's a cool color. What do you think of the open source segment? Is it cool?
Very good.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes, cool.
Do you want to try? You want to try some open source? Do you want to maybe do a quick lure color for your perch fishing, and then maybe you take that color.
Yeah, of course,
do a little quick color for a perch, and then you can apply it to whatever lure you want. If you do it later, or if you don't.
Yeah.
But I mean,
yeah,
what do you say, guys?
Yeah, we can try it out.
We didn't schedule this. I just thought about it. Like, what the
I'm
f? Let's open source.
Yeah.
So let Sarah get ready. Are you guys
Should
ready
I
for
take
a?
Take the flat nose or?
Yeah, we use the flat nose as base
for the color.
Yeah. And then exactly.
Do you like the red ghost? I want the
red ghost. Copy.
Yeah. We're doing a improvised open source with Stockholm Fiske here, Linus and Tom, the winners of Perch Pro 2016. I can see Sarah has now loaded her
screen.
Should
I get Matilda so she can help out with
the
comments?
Yeah, get her in here, like, right now. And you guys, you hang tight, you prepare yourself.
I'll come
here. Yeah. Where have you been?
It was problem with the cab.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
No,
it's okay.
You have to build a bigger room.
Yeah, I know. It's Pontus. He's hogging the biggest office, and we keep telling him, like, you don't need an office this size. If you just keep your shit together, see what it looks like.
Yeah.
He can start a fire. Okay, how are you doing, Sarah?
Yeah, I'm ready.
You were born ready.
Yeah.
There we go. Here's the window. There we go. We bring that up in the background, and this is it. This down there is lower third. Awesome. So we're using the flat nose as base, as we said, and we're gonna work our way up to. Do you already now maybe know some sort of lure that you want to apply this color to?
Yeah, I might do it on the grubby shad.
On the grubby shad, yeah. So
because it has a nice swimming pattern body, so
yeah, maybe it's gonna happen on the grubby shad, and then it's gonna be exclusively for stockholmsfiske.se. You can go to the video description in the bottom if you're watching this afterwards. Go check up Tom's ecom, and obviously if this one goes in there, you can purchase something or follow us. Do you have a newsletter?
Newsletter.
You have a newsletter?
Yeah, I have it, but we are not so active on the newsletter.
But you have the Instagram, right?
Yeah, Instagram, Facebook.
Stockholm Fiske on Instagram, yeah. You keep an eye out there for updates, and we will also announce it here if it happens, so you don't miss it. Let's start. So we're imagining the grubby shad, and quickly, let me just show you guys a grubby shad. Maybe you do it, Sarah.
Okay.
Take up a grubby shad. We have one in this package here somewhere.
Do we?
Mm-hmm. Tobias is screaming on the ice. Give me a second. Tobias?
Yes?
How are you doing out there? Are you catching?
Yeah, we are catching some small perch, but it's really windy today, and Philip's chair, it blew away on the ice, and now he's like half a kilometer away from here and trying to catch it.
Okay, keep us updated. Let us know if something happens.
Yeah.
All right, okay. This is the Gunky Grubby Shad. And so this is what you can sort of imagine yourself that this color will apply to.
Yeah.
But we'll use the flat nose thing
as a base. Yeah.
Okay, here we go. Do we have any suggestion? Come on, guys, you get to design a grubby shad color today. Come on. Let's do it. Do we getting any comments on that? Everyone is like shocked. Like, what are we doing? We just had an hour of open source session.
Are we doing another one?
Yeah, sorry, you weren't here, so let me fill you in. We're just improvising. I just came up with the crazy idea that we should do an open source on the grubby shad.
Fun.
And so Tom and Linus get to sort of lead here.
Yeah.
And we'll create one, and then maybe they'll stock it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Fun.
Yeah. So let's start with base color. Have you seen the open source segment before?
Yeah, I've seen it.
Yeah. So now we're starting with base color. So you can watch the comments. Can you see any comments on there? Let me bring it up here also, maybe. See if we have enough CPU to do this. And you will be able to follow. No, I can't get the comments here. So
I can.
Can you show the comments, Sarah?
Yeah, I have them here.
There you have them.
Okay, yeah.
Orange belly.
It's purple. Okay, with the base start, purple. I've seen purple, white.
They want purple.
Yeah, purple is not one. Or pink. It's a good base to do. Belly long. It depends on what we should do, a summer lore or a spring or a fall lore.
I think, of course, it depends, and it depends also where they want to fish with it. But right now, everyone is just going crazy and not thinking. So they just want a cool color. And I guess we don't know, since this was, we didn't plan this.
No.
it's going to be 6 months to a year before you can apply it to the market. So I'd say it's a spring lure, actually.
Yeah, spring.
It's for this sort of season. Just to be sure. So we are watching the comments, and there's pink, 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 lava red, pink, pink, pink. We're obviously going to more towards...
It's most of the people say purple, not pink.
Okay. White now.
Yeah. White and purple, some say.
Okay. Purple base. White. Start with purple base.
Okay.
Light or...
Take a light purple base, I think. Yeah, that's best.
Yeah. You're now thinking that you want to use this lure somewhere in the water to fish a lot?
Course,
yeah, of course. Yeah, it's like, I have a chance to design it. Yeah.
Is this like purple?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So now the fans have said what they want, and Tom is tweaking it, so he'll work around your waters and obviously your clients that you have in this local area. So that's a smart way to do it, for sure. All right, so a little bit more purple.
Like this?
More.
Yeah.
You lead Tom.
Yeah, I think that's quite good.
And as you can see, the colors in all the screens are offsetting a little bit.
Yeah.
So we'll see how it goes.
So purple base it is. Let's see what.
And some people say white too.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I like the white ones.
Yeah.
Maybe some white in the purple.
Exactly.
You can have a field like.
Yeah.
Yeah. Maybe you can go totally crazy here. Since these are being manufactured in a long thingy, a longer process, we can get a little bit more complicated if we want. Because we will have time to adjust it and tweak it to perfection. What are you thinking here, Tom? What is the audience thinking?
They want it darker, but they don't see the color that we see.
No, exactly.
Nah.
Okay.
So it is darker.
Now it's getting darker here too, so yeah.
Yeah, okay, yeah.
And Tom says white. Linus also says white, I think.
Yeah.
Linus says white.
Like a white belly or?
Yeah.
No, I think you should make a field in the middle of the lure.
Okay,
stripe. Like
deck.
Yeah, or like a, what do you call it, a round...
In the middle.
Oval.
Okay, I don't really get it, but...
Titta på mig. En ovalt område.
Yeah. Like here?
You can start further in front of the...
Nära ögat. It's gonna be a little Swedish here to make it go...
Yeah.
make it smooth.
We're so bad at English.
but it's
that's
fun.
That's the reason.
Yeah. Sarah's working all her brushes
maybe
there.
We can take one of these. Like this? You mean like this?
Yeah, and then draw it longer.
Okay, sorry.
So you have a thinner line of it.
We can move it and adjust it.
Yeah.
Oh, stretch it out more, Sarah. Make it. Yeah, there you go. Now I see
like
what, you're, what you mean.
Yeah.
More?
Yeah, more.
Even more?
Yeah, that, I think they're... Yeah, something like that.
Cool.
That's cool.
Yeah.
That's cool.
Oops.
Now, you should bring up the grubby shad again so we can take a look at it, Sarah, just so we can imagine what the actual...
Yeah, because the tail, maybe you have to move it in up front, because you see the tail is...
Yeah.
It's here.
Mm.
Non-colored.
Like this?
Yeah, like that.
Yeah, cool.
Yeah.
So is it supposed to look like the grubby shad, or is it...
Yeah, it should be a grub shot.
Okay,
yeah. Yeah. We're just using this one as base because we don't have the...
Oh, okay.
See, we don't have the
Okay, so the shape of a grubber shed, but another...
Exactly.
Yeah, you
exactly.
Now color on the
yeah, okay. Yeah.
Orange hook set point on the chin.
Orange hook set point on the cheek.
Like here?
Flue orange.
Okay, let's see. Like this.
Oh, who was it? It was the winner for one of the tickets for the event.
Yeah.
This Friday, and he's also here. His white belly.
Yeah, he's been commenting about this one. It's so fun to read.
Yeah.
Should we take the orange on the?
Yeah. Sorry, I was waiting for you, Sarah. Yeah, let's punch in the orange. Keep it going there.
Like where here or?
What do you think, Tom?
I think you should make it like that.
Like this?
Yeah. Yeah. Ooh. Perfect. Perfect.
Nice.
Yeah, I can totally see that on the gravity.
Yeah.
Perfect.
Just so you guys know, after this session is done, we're going to fix it and we're going to publish it on your Instagram and our Instagram as a grubby.
Yeah.
So, a grubby chat. I will fix that. I don't want to fire up my editing thing now. It's going to crash.
Yeah.
CPU is not so good. So. This is good enough.
Take help from Pontus and he will make a grubby shed. Make this in grubby shed. That's cool.
We'll be lovely with a glowing gold glitter around in the eye with a red dot in the middle.
We're going full screen here, I can tell you that.
Some glitter around the eye.
Yeah, and the grey field around the eye, if you can make that gold glitter.
I will make dots, I think.
Pink is a really good color when it's cold in the water.
It's funny you say that. I spoke to Stefan Trumstedt right after the session with the pink one with Albin last week, because Albin said the same about cold water for pink.
Yeah.
And Stefan and I had a conversation about it too. And then I started thinking, do you remember that ice out with Flams and Trams, ice out?
Yeah.
When I'm just hammering them with a pink pig.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's cold, it's ice out. It's like 1 degree in the water. I was going for it. I'm going to show it to you.
Do you mean like this?
Look.
Golden glitter?
Yeah, golden glitter around.
In this area? In
yeah,
the gray
in
area.
That area, yeah.
So this is Tom's slur.
Open source, Tom.
You remember that captain thing I asked about earlier? You're like, I can totally see that. Yeah. You had that little decision time for a while, but obviously we're not fishing your waters with this.
It's his waters.
Yeah. That's good.
Yeah.
Picked up on that fast. I was kind of waiting for it. When is he going to say that? Good. Good on you. Okay. See if I can find it. Flams and Trams, ice
this will fit you in the fish episode, I think.
Yeah, for sure. Pinklers.
I heard you guys are going fishing with fish.
Hmm?
Are you guys going fishing again soon?
Yeah, this weekend.
Yeah.
Upcoming weekend.
We'll is that when you're going to have your first fight?
Yeah.
Some open water. She's going to the water because I'm going to catch the biggest pie.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Good luck.
Good luck.
Good luck.
Yeah.
There it is.
Ice out.
Yeah. You see the pink pig?
Yeah.
Hang
on. Let me just bring that up for everybody.
I like your hair, John.
Thank you.
Nice one. Den är groteskt fet, Johan.
Det är helt sjukt. Det är helt sjukt. Vilken hona. Du får gå tillbaka snabbt så hon får... göra sitt, så att säga.
Får se en hel bild på den.
Was it the, yeah, it was the pink pig.
Oj, vilken jävla fisk.
You can see the pink pig in picture.
Yeah, you could see it in the beginning.
Yeah, there it is.
It's a great lure.
Yeah, and...
Gustav actually here comments that better for Tom to design it. We've already done one. So this is your lure to design.
And, yeah.
Should have a red dot in the middle of the eye. And then make it all bright red.
Yeah. The whole eye, red.
Yeah.
Okay.
Do they like what he's doing? Tom is taking over. I like it.
Yeah, I like it too.
They like it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, like red.
Yeah, I guess maybe a small black dot in the middle.
Okay, and you want this red?
Yeah, you can have a really bright red because you get the hook set from that too.
Like this?
Yeah.
And the viewers are actually saying here that, you know, let Tom decide. Design we already did one, so you just go crazy.
I just
crazy,
said
Tom.
That.
Yeah.
Okay, let's go crazy.
And
yeah.
Then a black dot. Like that, maybe a little bit harder.
Crazy eye.
Yeah.
I have a boomerang pattern of white over
stripes.
Boomerang stripes.
Like this? Like
but
one
on,
of that
on,
one?
Yeah, but on that direction.
Okay, the other direction. Well, I have to paint one myself then.
So how is the ice fishing going for the guys?
I think they're catching a lot of small perch right now. They're having problems with perch stealing the bait and they're
what color on these ones?
Make them white, I think, with the white.
The lake they're fishing is supposedly, I mean, they have caught big pikes there, so they're probably going to have to go through a lot of perch to catch one. Like, after that last show last Sunday, they want to catch a 10 kilo on the live. That's what it is for me. That's why I go do these stupid things with close framing and stuff, because I want to catch a big one live. Like I went to Florida and caught shark live, like.
Yeah,
because live is like you want to do it all over again. All the things you already done on camera, you want to redo live. I guess it's like fly fishing.
Yeah.
You know, you start with spin fishing and then you evolve into fly fishing because you want to make things more difficult and more and fish in a different segment.
It's something special with fly fishing too.
Absolutely.
What do you think about this? A little bit.
Well, I would like more like a boomerang shape, like a V.
Okay, more. Maybe can make it like. No, it's too. Let's delete this one.
You can just use the brush and go like that.
Yeah.
Like a V. And as we said before, this is a sketch, rough sketch. So, whoa, that was cool.
No.
I got a question for Tom. Meanwhile, we're waiting. It's from Aho Mikael Aho.
Yeah.
His name was Mikael, right?
Yeah.
Tell us your color preferences during spring, summer versus fall.
In the spring, I usually go by pink. But, you know, Grubby Shad had a pink eyes before.
Yeah.
That was a superb lure for the spring time. And also some blue silver works great in the cold water conditions. And in summertime, I go for as close to natural baits as possible.
Okay.
And I like them to be like perch colored with the stripes and everything on in the summertime.
Yes.
And in the fall, I go for like red ghost patterns that looks like that.
Yeah.
And I want, I always want a lot of movement in the shads. I don't want stiff shads. I want soft bodies in the shads. That's very important.
No non-action.
Now in the spring you can use non-action jigs, but then I want shads with a lot of movement.
Okay, so soft, as you said, big paddles.
Yeah.
Are we talking pike, perch, or both?
Both. Doesn't matter because the reaction is the same for all the species. So.
Yeah. Okay. Good.
Yeah.
How are we doing here?
Almost. Vill du ha det som en abborre?
Yeah, like
du vet om en abborre. Fast sen är jag bara en som är jävla.
Vill du testa lite själva? Jag är så inskränkt. Kör!
Det är jättedåligt.
Här tar du pappret annars, hörni.
Picasso is gonna work here. Like
paper and pen. I haven't seen that in a while.
Precis som vanligt.
Okej, okay, nu vill ha den liksom här vid ögat, eller?
Flera ränder, okej. Okay. Vill ha dem via... via. Ja,
som en lite, lite som en boomerang.
Ja.
Men vadå, typ sådär då?
Ja, samtidigt. Typ.
Okej.
Okay. Sådär ser det ut. Typ sådär.
Ja. Ish.
Ish.
Ish, ish.
We can fix this better afterwards.
Den där framme, är det den du pratar om? Eller menar du bak på ryggen?
Jag tänkte om man går över...
hela betet.
We switch over to Swedish now.
Så abborränder, inte på gälen, det menar de inte.
No.
Utan okay, so backa där, tillbaka och gör den smal igen. Den här vet som du hade.
Ja. Här eller?
Ja, exakt. Där ska du ha ditt V som du hade. Mm. So stay with the V.
Yeah. Like
yeah. And that's ready now. Yeah. And now we're moving the body.
Yeah, okay.
So now we're doing the perch stripe. Okay. A little misunderstanding.
Okay, we'll over good. Here.
Mm-hmm.
Over this oval.
Over the back.
Okay.
And over white. The oval. And over everything.
White.
Or maybe gray. If
gray color.
Yeah, to get some difference.
Yeah.
Like this.
Yeah. Okay, we do it.
Och nu är det liksom som en...
Here, Tom, you drive.
I'm out.
Ska de vara
tjocka liksom?
Yeah, yeah. Thicker now.
Vi sitter lite.
While these guys are designing, I will take this opportunity to tell you to go to my Facebook or go to your web browser when you have time, and you should check out a really cool blog that is called Fiske för alla.
Yeah. Well,
and it's a Swedish.
Like,
it's a Swedish blog. Three guys who love to fish. Unfortunately, they only write in Swedish right now, but it's very well written. It's the best blog I've ever read, actually. Best one ever.
No doubt.
And good guys.
Yeah. Fiske för alla. Dar.se, I think. Or
and we met them at the final of Perch Pro.
Yeah. They did a whole piece on Perch Pro. And we didn't ask them or anything. They just came up with the idea themselves. So they have pictures. They talk to people at the show. At the Perch Pro event. And they just summed it up so good. So if you want to know what it was like to be there and get a second opinion about the party... go there. There's actually a little bit of videos in there as well,
yeah.
Too. So yeah.
Or if you just want to read about fishing, good fishing. You've been there in an article.
I was there in an article. Yeah. They did a 10 profiles on fishing on the fall.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So cool.
Yeah, really putting their back into it, and I really want to highlight them and recommend them. And when we were at the Purge Pro event, I noticed that everybody came up to them and they were like,
"Yeah,
your blog is like the shit."
Yeah.
Yeah. Didn't know you could do stuff like that. Have you read them?
Yeah, I love them.
Yeah.
Book, yeah, it's
and the guys are great. Like, you just love them. It's like...
yeah, really nice guys.
Yeah. Super good. And one of them enjoys lure building too. He's got a little lure building video out there.
Yeah, I saw it.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. He's doing molds and doing two pieces and all sorts
that
of stuff. Yeah.
Check it out.
Yeah, for sure.
Really tips are even hard, liksom.
Yeah. And then you put the all in the
yeah,
same.
Exactly.
Yeah,
exactly. And the bottle ska man...
har du, de blir lite konstiga då?
Ja.
Det är du som har gjort den.
Ja, det är det.
Hur vill du ha... okej, okay, du vill ha en zigzag.
Yeah, like a zigzag pattern.
Men du menar att den kanske ska följa ryggen?
Precis, hela...
ja, inte gå ner så där och sen upp. Du kanske menar det så här.
Ta till perch.
Ja, till, ja, det, ja, någonting.
Eller istället för så. Precis, eller var det så?
Nej, men du kan ta lite upp så också.
Sådär, sa
ja,
det är så.
Det blir bättre, ja, det ser bättre.
Ja. Ja, bara, det är så.
Inte, ja, men det är bra.
Så där kan det inte se ut.
Who drives now?
Yeah, that actually...
now it's...
that can be something, yeah.
It's going towards purchase embryo stage or... yeah.
Yeah, something like that. I think the color is going to work.
Yeah.
Work out
really good, yeah.
Yeah. So, are we there?
Yeah, I think we're...
now we have the naming ceremony left. I think it's important. Maybe, you know what we should do?
We shouldn't name it now.
No.
We should...
Let the audience name it.
Yeah, yeah. We should do that, yeah. But you should come back for the live and do a naming ceremony, maybe something else involving around your show. I know we also talked about doing a show together at some point. Maybe we can have the naming inside that show and we can figure out if you're actually going to make it.
Yeah.
So now let's just name it Stockholms Fiske Open Store and keep it open.
Yeah.
And we'll come back to that segment.
Sounds good.
Yeah. But it's...
And we actually got a question of the size of the jig. Was it in 6 or 8.5 centimeters?
8.5
8.5 Yeah. 8.5 centimeters. Okay, I got a question I've been thinking of it since last evening. I don't know if Sarah's already asking you guys, but you were fishing with a red ghost, right? In Perch Pro. Yeah.
I think so.
Yeah, you could admit that. Do you think you would win without the red ghost?
Good question.
I'm not sure.
Nobody knows.
Nobody knows, because it's impossible to answer that question. Yeah.
You were only fishing with a red ghost?
No. No, we fished a lot with the nitro shad.
Yeah,
and,
And
IV.
And scissor comb.
And did the perch bite as much on the other lures as on
no,
the red ghost?
No, the red ghost was the lure that... catch the most fish.
Cool. Yeah.
And gave us the most bites.
While you were fishing and I caught and I try out new lures.
Yeah, yeah, you were trying all the time.
Success more. Try it out.
Yeah.
Fun. Cool.
That's really fun. I'm thinking if you could use this lure next perch pro.
Yeah, and win the whole competition.
Yeah.
That would be something.
That would be weird. Like, so cool.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but if it's cold water condition, that color is going to work really good.
Yeah. Yeah, 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 for sure. Okay, guys, any more questions for these fellas here? They've done an amazing job in the live so far. You guys went from the Perch Pro event back home to sleep. You came here. You slept in what room were you?
No, I wasn't sleeping.
You weren't sleeping?
No.
No, you were just hanging out on the beanbags.
Yeah.
You were idle for a couple of hours. Like, I left like 5:15.
Yeah.
I took a cab. I was out of here.
Yeah.
I was the only. I was the last one standing. I think.
Yeah.
Were you there when we did the VJing? No. We're watching YouTube videos like the whole night.
No. Yeah. I was with Jesper.
Yeah. Yeah.
And,
yeah. I figured. Yeah.
Talked. Yeah.
Yeah. So. And because you had to go up 7 o'clock in the morning, to go to a on a you've been on an event.
Yeah.
Yeah, and now you come back. Today.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, not me. I've been home.
You've been home?
Yeah, I've been home.
You weren't, but you were at the event.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I was working.
That's why
I worked so much. I was working last day.
Yeah. Okay. So you had to go take care of the store and all that stuff.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. A lot of people coming in, congratulate you.
Oh, yeah. It was full house.
Full house?
Yeah, and I was so tired. With a big hangover. So.
Oh, that's amazing. Yeah. Okay. Cool, cool. All right, but now you're back here again, and yeah, you did great. Final call, guys. Any more questions, or then we're gonna round this up. We still got a lot of, we've got some quizzing left to do.
Yeah.
And you guys, you can stay here in the studio for hang out for a while if you need to leave. Feel free to leave or just stay here.
Yeah,
and
we can hang out.
We should get some headphones for you, so you can. We'll work on that.
Yeah.
I forgot.
The paper is there.
I forgot where we are.
Yeah, we're
can you
not
pres-
yeah, I don't
can
anywhere.
You,
I don't know either.
Can you present the next program point? I got crossed. We're not doing my blender.
No.
They took it away.
Oh.
It's not interesting enough, and I'm like, okay. I did some blending before I got here. Yeah.
Look.
We have the Pike Hero.
Are you trying to steal my idea?
Yeah. I'm sorry. And the suggestion came up in the open source. It's out of my hands. I have to do what the audience say.
Yeah.
But I think that they associate the banana with you so much now, since you did that thing in the shop. That because everyone is thinking of you and talking of you. So I'm not surprised that the banana idea came up today. It's interesting how that works. Yes, guys, we're moving on. The Pike Hero segment, the Pike Hero competition that is coming up on the Sport Fishing Fair is our next subject. If you haven't heard of Pike Hero, you should go to canalgratis.se/Pike Hero. Check it out. I think the registration is still open, even though it's full.
Yeah.
But you can go in there. We'll fix that later. A lot of people has signed up, and all of you signed up in good time. I know you just got your email the other week that you you made it. So we did a selection of the people signing up, and now we're meeting like 6,200 kids at the Sport Fishing Fair on March 18th, and we do casting. Means we're filming all the kids when they're talking to a jury, and then we'll send 10 to 14 kids through. They will go to a elimination, which takes place a month afterwards outside. Okay. And the elimination is on a Thursday, and after that it's gonna be four kids standing
on a Thursday.
On a Thursday. I know what you're gonna say now. Now we're gonna say, how are they gonna? They're gonna be in school. That's what you're gonna say, right?
No.
No.
But shouldn't this elimination be in the Sport Fishing Fair?
No. It's just a casting in the Sport Fishing Fair. It's good. I like it that you ask these questions because it's so hard to inform about us. Program segment that we haven't done before.
Yeah.
So it's the first time, it's always a big struggle. Like, guys, you need to catch fish, okay? Go out, catch fish.
Yeah.
Okay. Don't catch so many and bigger. Okay. Yeah, that's how we work it. Okay. So you got it. In the Sport Fishing Fair, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, there is casting. Means presenting yourself to a jury, you're going to get a couple of quick questions, and there might be a technical thing for you to do there. But nothing more. Then there will be a ticket, and 10 or 15 of you will be sent forth to elimination on a Thursday. And the elimination on a Thursday, that's a little bit more tough. Then it's going to be more technical things, and we really need to narrow it down. We want the four best kids in Sweden standing, and they will Friday, Saturday, and Sunday fish the new format Pike Hero, which is a pike competition, fly versus jerk style. That's what it is. And what do you guys think? Fun?
Yeah, I think it's going to be great.
Sounds really nice.
It's fun. It's going to be real fun to see the kids fish.
Fishing.
We had a couple of them in the Flamsutram sections, etc. And some of them have signed up for this. And I think we actually, Sarah, do you have some pictures ready for us there?
Yes. We have some kids that have tagged us in Instagram.
Yeah, let's just...
in their photos.
Let's bring that up here.
Yeah. Here we have one.
We're just showing you this so you'll get an idea what the average crazy Swede pike angler looks like.
Yeah.
10 to 14 years old.
Yeah. And we had one more. And here's you, Linus.
Yeah.
Cool.
Did you sign up?
Did you sign up?
Did you use the hashtag Pike Hero? Amazing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So this is two people that we will meet at the fair.
Yeah. A lot of fun. I'm really, really looking forward to that segment. And if you have questions about it, feel free to drop it. I can answer them now as good as I can. I guess it's not that much to say until we really... I can't believe this. Get it out. There's Tom. The program. This is the weird thing with this program is that it gets tired. See?
Yeah, he knows.
It's weird. I can click in the right places, but still, it's... So here we are. That's the Pike Hero.
Yeah.
Looking forward to that. Sport Fishing Fair. Be there. Sign up. Moving on.
Yeah, we have... who will win the Fly versus Jerk?
Yeah. Fly versus Jerk is starting Friday.
Yeah.
Fly versus Jerk is starting this Friday. Tickets available here. And we have a question for you guys. Who do you think will win Fly versus Jerk this year? That's going to be interesting. Who do you think? Do you know the teams?
Yeah, I know the teams.
Yeah, it's Strike Pro, and it's Shimano Storm,
yeah,
and it's Vision Sweden, and Vision Finland.
Yep, four teams.
Yeah, so two newcomers, Mattias Holgersson and Jesper Norell for Storm Shimano.
Mm-hmm.
And also we have Pierre Monieret, who is going to fish with Stefan Trumstedt this year. So French guy again.
Yeah.
And it's going to be some title in French.
Cool.
Yeah.
Who do you think will win?
I got my bet on Bauer.
Bauer, yeah.
And his team. He's a dangerous pike angler.
He is. He is. And as I said this Friday on the event, Ian Fly versus Jurgen Perch Pro, the Fly guys have the bigger fish in both formats, all over. That's crazy.
Also, the Finnish vision team can be
dangerous.
Yeah. Absolutely. Yeah. I think they have a lot of power this year.
Yeah. What does the audience think? Like, do we have any...
Vision Finland.
Big mom, I love.
I really think that we should create a straw poll around that. You can do that, Sarah. And punch in the four teams. And I think we should straw poll that to see actually what everyone is thinking. The anticipation now before. And then as we have live all the Sundays all the way up to the Sport Fishing Fair and the final, we will come back to these questions a couple of times and see how the anticipation and expectations change during the tournament. So right now, there's going to be a straw poll in a second. Go to... strawpoll.me. No, it's not up yet. In a second. Now both of the girls are typing, so I can't read any comments, but I guess it's fine. Let's check on Tobias here. How are you doing, Tobias?
We are still fishing four perch, and they are biting, but it's like one very small perch in every hole, so it's nothing.
Okay.
They are not on the same spot. They are like everywhere.
Okay. Did you eat something today?
No, I haven't it yet.
Okay.
Not yet.
Okay.
Philip is eating Giflar.
Giflar. Okay, sounds good. Sounds good. Okay, well, we'll be back with you in a second, guys.
Okay.
Okay, I've got the straw poll ready. It
feels so good to have to be as there.
Yeah.
Like
give
every
me
time
the number and
I
will post it on the Facebook.
Tune him up like that and I take him away.
6, 7, 5.
That's the best thing.
1, 2, 5, 2.
Perfect.
Straw poll is coming out, strawpoll.me/671.
6, 7, 5, 1, 2, 5, 2. Yeah, I will go to the result. See what.
There'll be no winner.
No winner.
Here we go. Strike Pro, Shimano Storm, Vision Finland, Vision Sweden. Who will win Fly versus Jerk this year? I'm actually getting nervous. Speaking on the microphone and stuff at the Perch Pro event, it wasn't, you know, it was just you guys there. It wasn't the Sport Fishing Fair is going to be
big,
a big stage. And where are we going to put Perch Pro next year?
Yeah.
It's going to get bigger because
we
were close to 200 or 200 or something at the event. So.
And it was packed.
We got a lot of stuff to think about.
Yeah. I think you've done an amazing job.
Thank you, Tom. Thank you so much. It's fun because when Perch Pro wasn't invented, when you and I started to talking, it was in that era.
Yeah.
And it was so fun when you said that... that you would support it. That was a big day. Big mark. All right, guys.
Let's see.
Tom, I know we haven't made any super plans yet for production and actually if we're actually going to, but if we're going to produce with you guys this year, what will we do?
Perch school.
Now we're talking.
Back to basics.
Back to basic?
Yeah. No, I want to... I get so many questions, you know.
Yeah.
How we think,
what we, how we fish and everything. It would be great to show it all.
Yeah.
In a show. And,
all right. When is a good time to film that? I'm actually asking you the real questions now because I'm trying to figure out.
I don't think it matters actually because spring or summer or fall, it doesn't matter because if you know the basics, you can catch them all year.
Yeah. Cool. No, we should definitely do that. We're gonna have to talk about that off camera later, but it'll be good fun, and we would be so honored to do it. I mean, it'll be, it's gonna be awesome. How are we doing on that poll, Sarah?
Yeah, Strike Pro is in the lead.
A lot of people cheering for Strike Pro.
Yeah.
It's weird, like Albin is also getting a lot of cheers. He had a big fan base.
Yeah.
Strike Pro has a big fan base.
Oh, yeah. Very popular.
And they've been around for a long time. But Albin hasn't. He's like he has in the sport fishing segment, but not as a known as a profile.
Oh, it's a lot.
So it's very interesting. Strike Pro, 48% is betting on Strike Pro.
Yep. Should we move on from this drop hole?
Yep. It's gonna sit there for a while, guys. So you know, feel free to jump in. At any time.
Yeah.
Why are you looking at me that way, Sarah?
You looked at me that way.
You forgot something.
No.
No, joking.
So if we should follow the schedule, it's time for Tobias.
Yeah, I'm just gonna quickly check if the satellite is ready. Tobias, are you ready to talk with us? Have you got something to show us?
One minute.
In 1 minute?
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah. Are you? Yeah. Okay. We need to buy them some time over there. You can just go whenever you feel like it, Tobias. I will be preparing the scene a little bit here. And, a lot of buttons. Yeah, the studio is a little bit too small, but...
Mm.
And we actually got a birthday kid
today. Yeah, we had.
From the... Top fans. When you were out fishing Flams Trams.
Yep.
August is today getting 14. So it's his birthday today.
Yeah, happy birthday. Cool. Happy birthday. 14.
Sarah, shouldn't you be singing?
No.
Oh, don't
please.
Go there.
Please do.
Okay, I will save your ears. It's okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah. All right.
Here you go.
When we're coming back from this segment, if we have time, we're also going to take a quick look at one of the first live show that we did.
Oh, I don't want to see that.
Yeah, it's actually fun sometimes to look back and, you know,
remember,
see what has happened. We have some technical problems with the feed from the ice. Tobias has chosen spots where he thinks that it's going to be big pikes. So it's always a big fight here at Canal Gratis. It's a trade-off because I in the studio want a good stream. And Tobias wants a big fish. So this time they're on a big fish spot. But to me, the satellite, it looks like they sort of have given up or something. It looks like they're ice fishing over there.
Yeah, they're pimping.
So, guys, what are you doing? Fill us in here.
Yeah, guys, what are you catching? Anything?
We are catching some perch here, but they're really small ones.
Yeah, they are quite small. But is this the biggest for today, Edwin?
This is my personal best
for today.
Perch today.
Yeah, but that was a decent one. It was like over 25 centimeters.
150
grams? Yeah.
Oh, flag!
Flag! Oh, flag behind us! My God!
5 meters!
Philip, take the sledge! Here we have a flag! Is it taking line, Edwin?
No!
Is it a fish?
What?
Yeah.
No!
Oh, nah.
Oh, it's a decent fish.
Okay.
I think it's
a small one.
I think it's small. Yes, small.
Yeah, okay, it was a small one.
Whoa.
Oh, take it very easy. Yeah, but at least it's a pike, and it was very fun. We were just like 10 meters
yeah
away from here. Then we got the fish.
It was funny.
The size of the day.
Yeah, the biggest one. We are catching really big fishes today during this. Live stream. First we catch a big fish, but it wasn't on the live stream. And then we catch a lot of small perch, and now we're catching a lot of small pikes. But
it's funny anyway.
Yeah.
We're catching them.
Yeah, good one. Let us back. But it's like this in this lake. You catch a lot of pike in that size, and then all of a sudden you catch a big one.
Yeah.
There are a lot of small pikes, but
yeah.
When they finally take the step to become a big pike, they will grow fast. Yeah. Okay, let's go back and do some ice fishing again. Yeah.
Catch here a big perch, Philip.
And in fact, Edwin is an old competition perch fisherman. So he has done this a lot. And I think he has won the team Swedish championship once. But Edwin, how you won in team? Pimpel as well. Ah, whatever. Okay, Philip, show some other perch here.
Yeah, I have.
We have them in this bucket, so we to show you guys. And also, we don't like to put the perch back in the hole again, because they can spook the whole school, and then you won't catch anything more. So we usually put them in this bucket with some water, and then later, when we think that we will not catch any more perch in that hole, we will release them. Here's another good size perch, not at all, but it's another perch.
You nice can colors.
Yeah, nice colors, another good one. Yeah, we got a question here, and they are wondering how thick the ice is, and it really depends on. We showed you guys before how thick it was, and over there, as you can see over there, where our camp is, it was like 9 centimeters.
But 5 centimeters.
Yeah, here it's like a current or something. So here it's like 5 or 6 centimeters, very very it's soft dangerous. Ice. So it's quite risky. I don't think we will fall in, but in a couple of days, I don't think we can fish here anymore.
No.
It's just today. And here, yeah, and I think I heard a bell somewhere. I'm not sure about that. Yeah. And then, if the ice will disappear, we will do some live streaming on open water and probably try your guys' open source colors and so on. Yeah. When we are here, we can show you some how to ice fish your perch. Perch Pro on ice. and here, we have a ice fishing perch rod. And it's... Okay, and how thick is the line, Edwin? On that one? 0.10?
Yes.
Okay, it's 0.10, so it's very, very, very thin line. And also, it's monofilament, because you do not want braided line when ice fishing for perch, because then it's very easy for them to get off the hook. Is it that right? Yeah, it will be too...
It's freezing too.
And also it's freezing, it will freeze. The braided line, it's not good for ice fishing, because the braided line sucks up water, and then if it's minus outside, the line, it will freeze, and then it can break very easy and so on. Yeah, and this is how you do it. Okay, Edwin, let's pretend you just drill a hole, so take up everything. Now he's coming to this place. And yeah, we can do another hole here. Let's do a new hole and show everyone how to do. Yeah. And also I want, okay. Here, that's good, it's a good place. This is how you, it's very, very windy today, as you can see. okay. First, you drill a hole. I think it's like... Yeah, And it's very, very, very important when you are fishing in competition to drill very fast. And then he has a new hole here, and now he wants to measure the depth. So, and the rod he has, it doesn't have any reel. So you like taking the perch up with your hands. But he is putting the lure back on the bottom, and then he will adjust the depth. So he wants to have the same. Now he know that when the
nu får ni verkligen dra en fisk här. Ni sitter i studion och kräver att ni får ta en fisk här.
Equal to the ice, he is on the bottom. Then he's just moving up the thing like 30 centimeters or something and making some very small jerks. And then it's very important to not make too hard jerks or pulls, because that will attract pikes. The perch is more like, it doesn't want as much movement, so you really need to be very, very, you need to make very small movements when fishing for perch.
Oh, I had one.
Did you have anything?
Yes, I had one.
What did you say?
Small perch.
Small perch. Missed it. Okay. But it was like
no,
this.
No.
Oh, it was like this. Lose today. It. You can cast like one small perch in each hole, then you have to move again, because they are very, very, they are like everywhere. You can't find a whole school of them. Are you biting all the time?
Yes, I lose.
Yeah.
They're biting all the time out there, but we're also losing a little bit of time here. Yeah. We'll put them, let's put them behind us. Oh, I hate my job. Here we go. Here they are. We'll keep an eye on them. We'll follow them over here and see if something happens. We are ready to move into our next segment here. I think it's time for quiz.
Yes, it is.
Yeah. You guys have a chance to win something. Mm-hmm. Not a bad thing. What are they winning, Sarah?
They're winning the tickets to entrance, 3 days,
yeah.
Entrance at the fair and after party. But you have to be 18 for the after party.
Yeah.
So
what happens is if they're 15 and they win?
They will go.
You're going to sneak them in the back door,
yeah,
right?
Exactly. No, they are going to have 3 days entrance at the fair.
Instead?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's
and
a good
you can
price.
Come and hang out at the Canal Gratis booth.
Hey.
Will you be there?
I hope so.
Yeah.
Yeah. Maybe not with display, but maybe...
No, I won't be there with the display.
But you will be there mingling around.
Yeah, mingling around.
Are you joining the Fly vs. Jerk final?
Yeah. That's the plan.
That's the plan. That's good.
Mm-hmm.
Being on the other side for a change. You know, see how the others are tortured. They're going to be up on stage watching it, so everybody's going to watch them. It's going to be bad, bad, bad. How are they doing? Are they catching anything? Or?
Don't know.
All right.
Okay, so the first question.
Yeah.
It's like a Perch Pro quiz, of course.
Yeah, explain how this is done. If we have new viewers here,
everybody needs
to be an update on the rules.
Yeah, you have to be as fast as you can to answer, because the first one that writes the right answer will have a point.
Yeah,
we can say a point. So be fast.
Mm. Be fast.
Yeah, okay. One. What's Truma's most famous phrase in all time in Canal Gratis production? 1, 2, 3. I think everyone knows this. Okay, we're waiting for the answers.
And what's Sarah's most used phrase in all time? No, gratis production.
I can say that.
I'm scared of the pie.
Yeah.
That would be yours.
And awesome.
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 Nice.
Everything's
it's
awesome.
It's sick.
Demon style. You know who that is?
Sachanke?
Ja.
Yeah.
Dina aldrig, kan aldrig dra upp den här bilen.
Uh-huh.
Remember that? Last night? Yeah.
Okay, we got the right question.
Det är blött också.
Should we move on?
Yeah. Okay, this is a question from Perch Pro. And What did Albin hammer in episode 1 before they even started to fish?
Mm-hmm. In episode 1, yeah.
Episode 1 of yeah. Perch Pro this year. So, Albin Sjargi, what did he hammer
mm-hmm.
before they started to fish?
Mm. Am I tired or is it actually blinking like crazy?
It's blinking like crazy.
Yeah.
It's like a disco, that's nice.
That's nice. We'll go away, blink.
You're preparing yourself for the Fly versus Jerk after party. I see that. Blinking, disco.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah.
This program is so weird. Like, I'm loading the background, I'm sending it out there, and it's not moving out there. Like, I... Okay. Secret message.
Okay, you got the right answer.
Yeah.
So should we move on?
Yes.
Mm.
Okay, warning for spoiling, but we don't have to say
spoiler
that.
Spoiler alert
we, yeah,
for Perch Pro?
Yeah. We spoiled everything already. Okay, what did Daniel Bergman promise to do if they have been the winners of Perch Pro? That had been fun.
But they have been...
Yeah, mm-hmm. If they was the winners of Perch Pro.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
He promised to do something.
Oh, yeah. I know where you're coming from now.
Mm-hmm.
We're good.
So, what did he promise? So, it was when you were outside and talking to them, Johan?
Yeah.
In the episode 1, you were asking all of them questions.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and he promised you one thing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's what it is. Good questions.
Yeah.
I can tell you're really following the formats. I'm so glad.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah. It's actually, everyone takes it for granted that we watch everything, but it's actually hard. We're producing many production hours every... and
It's many of the old films that I haven't seen.
No.
It's
a huge archive now. It's like 500 something videos.
You have to keep it up.
Yeah. So for when we're bringing someone on the team,
mm-hmm.
they actually have to spend a lot of time just catching up because...
Yeah.
Like, when we were sitting here and for the after party, a lot of your friends reacted to, like, when they saw the whole archive,
yeah.
and they were like, I haven't seen that, I've never seen that, I've never, because you think you've seen them all, but there's just so many videos in there.
Okay,
yeah.
Question 4.
Yeah.
Question number 4. Stefan Jensen told us about their tactic before the competition in episode 1. Would they go for the numbers or go for the big fish?
Mm-hmm.
Fly fishing in Perch Pro.
Really?
Well, there you go.
well, I think that will work. Yeah. Cool.
I feel so bad when they are on the starting line. Like, I have to roast them a little bit.
Yeah, because of fly fishing.
It's going to get a little bit worse. And next season on Fly vs. Shark is going to be a different setup. We're actually making some huge changes to the format.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yeah.
Something you can tell?
No. Those who know there are a couple of people who is inside the circle who knows, and hopefully they haven't said anything. I haven't heard the rumors that Lee's swimming back. I can let you guys in on this also when we have turned off the camera. It has to stay secret for a little bit longer.
Yeah.
Maybe we'll announce it. At the sport fishing final, but there are
some things that has to
mm-hmm.
work.
Yeah.
Okay, next question. Okay, Tom here managed to catch a perch with an unusual technique, eating and fishing with a...
Oh my God.
Everyone has to know that.
What can it be?
Yeah. That's like the best in the whole show, I think.
The best was his reaction that he didn't see on the camera.
What reaction? Your reaction? Well, the winning? When he can't speak?
No.
When he caught a perch on the banana.
Oh.
You did?
No. When he does that.
Yeah, you did, but that's in the show, right?
Yeah, but not all. He was completely down.
Okay.
Tired,
I think we have that on camera.
Yeah.
We have a huge, because we have a lot of audience asking for deleted scenes. So we have a huge archive of deleted really cool material, but we don't have anyone to take care of. Like I could have somebody working full time for a year, just producing deleted scenes.
Imagine.
Yeah, there's so much stuff, but because you gotta have a lot of respect when you do that, because you know it's awkward things like that. So it's a big process, and that's why we haven't aired them yet, because. I haven't done them yet because it's a lot of work to process. Like when you edit funny stuff like that, you need approval of the people you're filming. And so it's a bit of a struggle. But in the future, we will have... We're already getting...
Looper special.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. We're hiring more staff all the time.
Yeah.
So and that's our sort of... Now we have camera guys, we have producers, we have all that stuff. And now we're actually moving towards hiring people who's working with the aftermarket, taking care of the videos that are already up there, making sure annotation links are working. Jukke is already with us a little bit now. He's testing with the team. He's doing channel programming. Like some of you guys have already seen that we're translating a lot of the videos on the channel. And we're going to have also people coming in. Somebody's going to have to soon work full time on translating.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So it's gonna take years to get it all the way up there where we want it, but we're slowly.
Okay.
It's happening. Okay,
sure.
I'm gonna shut up now.
Next question.
Yeah, please.
Stop talking.
No.
Okay, our other guest, Linus, he's
mm-hmm.
in another team. So what's the team name of Linus' team aside of Perch Pro?
Yep.
So not the Perch Pro team. On your spare time,
mm-hmm.
yeah,
with your guys.
Someone's here asking you, Johan, is there gonna be a Sander Pro version?
A lot of people asked for that, of course.
Mm-hmm.
And there was actually a suggestion, which I presented to the business 2 years ago. And it was interesting to some people, and to some people it was not interesting.
Mm-hmm.
But let's just say that we have the capacity at Canal Gratis at producing it. We have a different, slightly different way, an idea of how to produce it. But we don't have any Perch Pro competitors to bring on the show. And there's not any real companies who wants to support that yet. So it's a little bit too early. So what's going to happen, as it always happened, as in Pike Hero, we're gonna do it anyway, but we're gonna do it our way a little bit. And then we're gonna have to make it fancy pantsy as we go.
Yeah.
So there's stuff coming.
Yeah, okay, next question. Frederick got a question from Ilux Skunky. If he felt comfortable before the competition, did he? Yes or no?
How would you be, Sarah?
I wouldn't feel comfortable at all.
You would have felt amazing.
Oh, yeah. With you by my side, of course.
Then maybe we should go to try catch bigger perch.
Yeah, maybe.
Yeah.
If we have a chance.
Sorry, give me 1 second
yes.
here. Tobias Ekvall, are you catching something?
Yeah. Got the flag,
yeah.
Like 2 meters.
Yeah, I can see that.
And I think you can see it on the camera.
So yeah, when you need to shake your cord, because we get frame dropping like crazy here. So shake your cord, and if you have a good fish,
it's good right now.
Yeah. So if it's a good fish, you let me know, and I'll flip. I'll just pass you through. Okay.
Yeah. Okay.
All right. It's cool. Okay, Tobias is going to take it from here. Let's go over to the satellite and see what the guys are doing out there. They are catching. This is exciting.
Okay. Okay. I think it's good right now.
And I'm actually receiving information here that there's no fish. I'm sorry. And we have huge interference. Back to the studio here. I'm sorry, guys. Oh. Sorry for the little interruption. And
got a fish.
Yeah. Okay. Where were we?
Yeah, last question.
Yeah, I got
You're
a
on
question
the last
more.
Question?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And earlier today, we had another guest, Thomas.
Mm-hmm.
From which country does Thomas come from?
Ooh.
I'm just looking through old video art. This is the one I'm looking for. I'm gonna show you guys when the quiz is over, as an end to this fantastic live show, I'm gonna show you a retro clip.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. And I'm also buying a little bit of time for Tobias and the boys out there, see if they... Because they... You can immediately tell when they start getting the bites, and then all of a sudden, boom, there's a big one. Ice fishing is so different when it comes to that. But like I said, they're having a lot of technical problems today with the broadcast.
Mm-hmm. It's worked anyway. We're seeing some things from the ice.
Are you guys... we're going to do a couple of... Yeah, we're going to do one. We're going to do one... little segment here, just to round things up. I want to show. Are you guys ready?
Hmm.
Everything's good.
Yes.
Okay. So we're close to closing this live session. I'm just gonna let Tobias Ekvall.
Yes.
This is the live studio. Yeah. We're. How are you doing? Are you catching anything or no? I saw you lost one there.
Yeah. No. I got it.
Okay. Is there anything else you'd like to add before we sort of wrap this up? No.
It was very fun to fish today. We caught a lot of flags, but they were like, every fish was small, but except the first one we caught.
Yeah. You know what?
That's what it is on this lake. You caught a lot of one, then all of a sudden it's a big one.
So Tobias, I have an idea here. You're live, everybody can hear you, so, you know, don't yell at me. but I'm thinking here, should I post, I could post... your live fishing live, like I can post another clip with your video feed if you still want to ice fish and live fish and people still want to follow you maybe through the day if you catch, because last time you caught something big in the end of the day and everybody missed that.
Yeah, we did, and we could probably do that, not today, because we have a lot of, there's like black spots where you don't have any feed.
Okay.
So it's good connection in some places. So that would be a very good idea, but not today.
Not today. Okay, good. So thank you from the ice to BS, and we'll speak to you soon. Okay.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you.
Thank you. Sorry, guys. I know you missed the sound there a little bit. I just wanted to check and see if they could continue the broadcast after we close here, but we're not doing that today, obviously, due to technical issues, etc. Thank you, guys, for joining the studio.
Thank you for inviting us.
Big congratulations on first place in Perch Pro 2016. I'm gonna show a clip now when we leave you guys, and it's not a perch clip. It's a pike clip. This is actually the I'm actually thinking that you guys haven't seen this. This is the very first fly versus jerk teaser.
Oh.
Have you seen it?
No, I don't think so.
You haven't seen it? No one has seen it? Is there anyone in the audience who have seen it? Have you seen the Fly vs. Jerk teaser thingy? I don't think so. Let's roll it and find out.